All right, let's do a cheers to the Sobey Sustainable Liquid Beer for the Week podcast.
We ride again.
I love you guys.
Careful. That takes off.
Good morning, Edmonton, and those of you watching around the world on YouTube or listening around the world, and some of you are on TuneIn or on iHeart or at EdmontonSportsTalk.com and your convenient web player. What a game. What a finish. Extra time needed. And they still find a way to get it done. On the road against the Bucks. Austin Reaves, clutch. Austin Reaves comes up huge. Logo three, final 2 minutes. In overtime, he was great. D'Angelo Russell was great. Did you see Anthony Davis's block on Dame at the end of OT1? Incredible stuff. Incredible stuff last
What's
night.
What's better than one overtime? Two overtimes, right? That's exactly what you...
You know, it's also nice. Joking aside.
AD 34,
AD was huge. No LeBron. They like a signature win. Signature win, that was huge. But let's get to the real story here. A guy who was unfairly criticized, stepping up in a huge way for his team in a victory last night. Jesse Puljujarvi's third of the season for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Are you kidding me? That's a guy? See that shot? God, there's a little bit of traffic in front. It was great.
Some would say they're out of the wild card race. But not Jesse Puljujarvi.
Jesse Puljujarvi.
No, sir.
I don't know if you noticed last night, but Jesse Puljujarvi and Sidney Crosby will not be denied. So this is big, too. This is big, too.
Got your keyword coming up?
I don't even know the keyword. Trevor, you're going to have to text me the keyword.
Hey, did we find the key?
No, like the keywords are gone.
So did somebody steal it from the Beaumont Boston Pizza? What's going on here?
I didn't have them at Boston Pizza. Oh. I swear to God. Somebody stole my Vegas keyword list from this office.
So it's an in-house.
We just have to watch and see who's texting in the keyword right before we say the keyword.
Gager.
First to show me to know this. All right, we've got lots to get to today, obviously. If you're watching on YouTube, hammer the
hammer
the thumbs up.
Happy first annual inaugural Wednesday right?
A quick story about that with my wife. She goes, I didn't even bring it up, but... And I have a great soundboard here, which is...
Who's this?
Who's this?
Where is Owen? I want my bath!
I want a bath! Anyway, Tab, last night, the kids are in bed. And no, actually, the kids weren't even in bed. She said this in front of the kids. She goes, and now what's this, this Owen thing on Owen Wednesday? She goes, you know, she goes, you have a really good show, and then you go and you do something very stupid like this.
Well, I beg to differ.
I was like, what are you?
I says, pardon.
What are you talking about? I just want a soda with ice.
Get me a soda with some ice in it.
Has she seen the movie? Like, are we?
No, I don't know if she has.
This needs to be a Nielsen movie night then, maybe. Hey, a little Easter special with the kids.
I don't know.
You're ready to tell them to take me away.
Wednesday. We'll see where this goes. Yeah, I mean, it might be a one-off, but there's a lot of good. We got a lot of good.
I asked for the salted nuts. He brought me the unsalted nuts.
Okay. Let's try to move along here.
You little bastard, I said you deserve me.
You little bastard. I said you deserve me. Oh, too good, man. Anyway. Oh, Wednesdays. This is going to be interesting to see where this goes. All right, but look, obviously the Oilers, Jets, lots to discuss coming out of that game. Lots of goal songs to hit coming out of that game. Connor Brown goal song is on the way today. Nugent Hopkins goal song is on the way today. Oof. Leon Draisaitl goal song is on the way today. All happening in the 6 o'clock hour. We're mixing some in the 7 o'clock hour and, of course, in the 8 o'clock hour. But no McNuge song today. I did see somebody be like, hook that McNuge song into my veins. But that's only when it's an even strength goal. Nuge's goal is a power play goal last night, so let's not get too greedy. But let's start the show with a little Zach Hyman. Overtime hero. Here we go.
Hey, everyone. I'm Zach Hyman of the Edmonton Oilers.
She's so tenacious.
Hope you guys enjoy it.
Revving up his engine, listen to the crowd just roar. No reason for tension, Zach is gonna shoot and score. Hyman's in the scoring zone. Right into the scoring zone. Signed for 7 years, now he's playing by McDavid's side. He's got you jumping out of your seat cause of that look in his eyes. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone. You playing with Connor, it's a top line overload. You'll finally see what he can do. So raise your hands up as high as they can go.
You little bastard, I said you deserved me. Owen loves his mom. Owen loves his mom.
He always said that was a magician's secret.
And his energy is contagious.
Playing with an edge, that's what you're gonna see. Taking the next step, cause he's no longer with the Leafs. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone.
Oh, Zach Hyman does it again. The 200th goal of his career. And he has scored a quarter of his NHL career goals this season, which is a pretty damn impressive run.
What does it mean?
Well, you know what? We will, by the way, all of our goal songs brought to you by Sportball. Check it out. Put your kids in Sportball today. You don't have to be rich to do it. www.sportball.ca for more info. They're filling up all of their summer programs right now. It's going to be a good day for Sportball today because we got a lot of goal songs that we're going to get to. I know some of you are looking for reaction to the idiot Berkshire's take on Zach Hyman, the weird, jealous, grudgy-like take that now has like 4.8 million views on X. We'll get to that with I Says Pardon coming up here around 6:50 this morning. We'll lay out the show for you. We got to get to that Connor Brown song right away, though. I mean, I can't really delay the Connor Brown song.
We waited long enough.
Especially, like, this guy's, what, like, the next goal Connor Brown scores, he's going to walk through three people and Forsberg it around the goalie. Because the first goal he scores, driving to the net, bounces off him, goes in.
Yeah.
Second goal he scores, goes to the net, rebound kicked out, buries it. Third goal last night, straight up snipe.
Yeah.
So what's next?
Where's that been hiding?
What other tricks does Connor Brown have up his sleeve?
Yeah, the magician, hey?
We'll get into,
put a hat on him, hey?
We'll
maybe
get into
for
that.
Easter, a rabbit. Wouldn't that
be something? Connor Brown goal song on the way as well. And I think we do have to, once again, give credit to the married couple who really got him off of the schneid so that Jonty and Victoria could walk, you know, could run. They walked so he could run.
They tried. And they've succeeded thus far.
It worked out very well.
Getting off that schneid, yeah.
Turning around. Here's the show for you today. We'll get your morning announcements right away. Morning after show coming up for EM Utility Locating. Don't kill yourself. Call EM Utility Locating because they are award-winning. I Says Pardon around 6:45 today. Craig Button, just after 7 o'clock this morning. Vegas keyword today will be at 7:20. Cool Bet Hotline of the Day. Free advice at 7:30 for Damon Bunting. Eric Macramalla, very interested to chat with Macramalla today about all this Ohtani stuff and just how does North American professional sports manage gambling and betting when it's going to be so heavily involved moving forward and their players are going to be clearly tempted by it and be looking at the league itself and going, well, how come you guys can cash in off all this stuff and I can't bet on myself to be under the total? So we'll get into that a little bit with Macramalla. Kind of easy trivia for Mr. Mike's. Three questions too many for Park Mazda. That's a good. We'll get to that for Italian Center Shop. We got a fresh dozen. We got a fresh
new
dozen
drop.
Sitting over there. New donuts for us. That's exciting. And then Greg Wyshynski. Phone problems be damned. Wyshynski will join us via video today at 8:30 this morning. And then at 8:40 this morning, Lieutenant Eric and I, with Jonathan the Tuba Man, we'll be playing the A&W song live today as you're looking for those two juicy mamas for $9.99 right now at A&W. You been thinking about your performance a bit?
I didn't sleep.
I didn't think you would. Let's listen to it without our instruments. We'll see. You got a lot going on there with that block.
There's absolutely no timing. Like, I don't understand.
The block, I don't know.
Whoever composed this piece was I don't know, there's something wrong in the mind.
Like, for the triangle, I kind of just got to get going.
Yeah, you get going, yeah.
But you got this, like, dude.
I'm offbeat, dunk, and then it's like I'm falling over or something like that. I practiced at the mirror for hours last night.
Good. We're ready. We're going to do that around 8:45 today, and if you think this is a joke, it's not.
Well, Jonathan's the lead hand. He's got us. Like, as long as he does his part, you know, the supporting cast, we can just kind of, you know, feed off what he's doing.
And there he is, Dr. J. That's the man.
That's Dr.
That's
J.
That's the man. Yeah. That's Dr. J.
Tuba Man.
he's coming in today. Tuba Man, Dr. J. He is a music teacher, but he does have a doctorate, so he's going to use that doctor handle, which I'll give him approval for. I mean, we might talk about it a little bit when he's in today.
The doctor will be in.
Yeah, right? Dr. J coming in at 8:45 today to play the tuba for us. And it is on him. I mean, if the song sucks,
well, that's what I'm saying.
He's the key part.
Nobody listens. You're not listening to that. What a triangle!
Nobody's coming in for
the
triangle.
Tuba.
As long as the triangle can just stay like this,
yeah,
I'll be fine.
Yeah,
but the tuba's got to deliver.
You don't even need to be plugged in.
Yeah.
Just like Ryan Gibson in an old teenage gentleman show one time ago.
All right, let's get into you. Well, let's go.
Guy was unplugged the whole show. He's playing guitar, and
nobody even
he's giving people thumbs up, and it's like, dude, you're not even.
That was in the old
show?
Band?
The whole
band.
Show, yeah.
God, that's the band where Locke played the
sounded good,
the
man.
Harmonica. Yeah. You're going very well. Morning announcements coming up, but look, Connor Brown, third of this season.
Off the Schneider.
This guy's red hot.
I think we're gonna be glad. I think it's today.
Yeah.
Connor Brown scored last night, his dragon is slain. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid.
Connor Brown's off of the shine. It's at my fucking time. He's had chances galore, two and ones and breakaways, yeah. But he could never score, even strength or power play. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. Got to play McDavid live. You should have scored one, you should have scored twice by now. And got to play alongside Dry. How could he not score? How did he not score? How? He's played on every line, but he's best on PK. Yeah. He can never find the twine till he found his last game. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time.
Oh, Jaunty in Victoria. That's a good one. That is a good one. I love it too. John T. Victoria in the nasty chat says, when I told my wife that Connor Brown scored again, she said, wow, he's really off the Schneider. God, I love her. She's trying. Yeah, that's.
I like that more than the Schneider, to be honest. Off the old Schneider.
That's a good one. That is a good one. Wheels is in too in the nasty chat today. Oh. Morning, AM Nasties. Hyman is smoking hot. I'm still trying to figure out how to make a pancake with that Costco pancake mix. You know, I briefly thought yesterday, maybe Atif meant he had a pancake maker and he couldn't make the pancakes
properly.
What's
a pancake maker?
I don't know, like something where you just pour it in, close it down, and makes a pancake for you. You know, like a waffle maker, but for pancakes. But apparently it wasn't the case. Apparently it was just a pancake mix.
He should be on the street by now hawking that stuff like you promised, hey?
I thought you would have moved it already on Facebook Marketplace.
You're missing the rush hour traffic there, Atif.
What the heck, Atif? 780-218-9999. That'll get you into the Paris Jewelers inbox, where you can visit parisjewelers.com. And get the flexible financing options. Do not pay until 2025 if you don't want to pay right now. 22 locations, Canadian, family-owned. It's the PJ's inbox.
It's the inbox.
Paris Jewelers inbox.
Bobby LaFrench checks into that inbox.
Oh, Bobby LaFrench.
You think Dick Venaretta is available to do a playoff post-game summary? He was on the Lakers beat last night, hey, for the over, like, wasn't yeah, that the thing?
Dick Vitterell last night was prepping for a podcast, is what he was doing last night.
Yeah, yeah. In the spirit of Gold Songs, too, I mean, look, yes, Puljujärvi did score.
No, there's too much. I don't want to be that guy. Ah. People are going to be like, Nielsen can't divorce himself from Jesse Puljujärvi. No, that's nice to see him score. He's at three goals now.
Same as...
Sometimes around here, we refer to that as an okay season. I could definitely be in the bottom six.
Yeah.
Your text of the day today, and there's some good Macramalla intros already rolling in. Yeah. It's that day. EST legal analyst and guy who finally got his 4.5 mil from Otani.
Yeah.
He's going to join us around 7:45
today. Breaks it on the show. He's the new interpreter.
Well, wouldn't that be something?
That'd be great.
I could see something
he's
like that.
He's repped bands before, right? Slipknot and such. Like, he knows his way around the stardom.
Macramalla has repped Slipknot?
Slipknot was part of... He was part of the firm that
like, managed Slipknot.
Yeah. Yeah.
I didn't have that on the bingo card.
Exactly.
Wow. That's interesting. A&W text of the day. What is better than one A&W Mama Burger made with perfectly seasoned grass beef patty, topped with pickles, slice of onion, ketchup, mustard, teen sauce, served on a toasted sesame seed bun. What's better, you ask? Two Mama Burgers for only $9.99. This only is until April 14th, so you got to hammer this. Enjoy two delicious mamas, mouth-watering, $9.99, participating A&W restaurants, Edmonton, St. Albert, Sherwood Park, and Devon. It's a great deal, and drive-thrus, for the most part, are open 24/7. All right, let's get your morning announcements for 100.3. The Bear!
Wow.
Oilers, a bit of an adventure last night, but obviously get it done. We'll dive into that more with your morning after show coming up for EM Utility Locating. But big night in the National Hockey League last night, and I think we have to start from the NHL perspective. The Nashville Predators, man.
Hey.
Like they're down 4-1 to the Vegas Golden Knights.
Exactly.
The Vegas Golden Knights, and everybody's probably thinking, uh-oh, the Knights, they're heating up. They're going to be the ones that roll into Nashville and hand them the L. But that was not the case. Nashville storms back. Ryan O'Reilly's 25th. Forsberg's 40th. Nyquist with his 20th. And I think Ryan O'Reilly referred to Forsberg and Nyquist as his Swedish meatballs, which I got a lot of time for.
I know the Claussen's line and all that, but this Swedish meatballs thing is...
in a weird turn of events, I'm actually going to IKEA this afternoon.
Get out of here.
And now we got the Swedish meatball reference.
Get some Dame candies as well.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't really. I like going there, but I also hate going there. So Tam and the kids are going early, like having lunch and stuff. Then I'm meeting them after.
That Dame cake is your UC Soros if you really want to kind of IKEA up the Preds lineup.
Is that how it works?
Big point, though, for the Golden Knights as well. I mean, a point back of the Kings who have won four in a row. Like, it was a weird night both in the West and the East.
Oh, all over the place with some of these games and the movement. So that was a big one. Nashville still hasn't lost in regulation in, like, forever.
And they won't lose again.
No.
Given last night. I mean,
that's an incredible comeback. Washington, 4-3 in overtime. Big win for the Caps.
Oh, huge.
Against the Detroit Red Wings. But the Bettman point, tis be granted to the Red Wings, just as it was to the Winnipeg Jets last night. Montreal goes into Colorado and beats the Habs 2-1.
As we were crowing about that home record yesterday a couple of times.
Now McKinnon still got his point.
28-7 now.
Point in every single game at home this season. The Boston Bruins, Florida Panthers, as they say in the biz, that's a battle of the heavies. That's a battle of the heavies. And the Boston Bruins, 4-3 in regulation on the road in Florida. The Rangers getting the extra point in overtime as they get by the Flyers 6-5 last night.
Sitting in that president's seat for the time being, hey?
That'd be a tight race.
There can only be one prez.
Pittsburgh trying to hang around. They had to have it. They beat the Hurricanes 4-1. The Devils into Toronto, double up the Maple Leafs 6-3. That's a tough one. And then Dallas is in that race, obviously, with Colorado and Winnipeg. They win 6-3 last night. So let's just take a quick look
at the West
standings right now. The Dallas Stars with 99 points sitting at the top of the West. Colorado and Winnipeg would be a first-round series if the playoffs started today. Hell of a series.
We'll take it.
Hell of a series. And the Nashville Predators are just 4 points back of the Winnipeg Jets. They both played 72 games. So that could be an interesting race here over the final 10. In the Pacific, Vancouver still with an 8-point cushion on the Oilers. The Oilers now with only 2 games in hand on the Canucks. The Kings, 87 points, 3 points back of the Oilers. And the Golden Knights, 1 point back of the Kings. The Kings have 1 game in hand on the Knights. The Oilers have 2 games in hand on the Knights. The Oilers have 1 game in hand on the Kings. And the Oilers and the Kings play Thursday night in what's just a massive tilly. That's a huge tilt, a big game between the two clubs. That should be a lot of fun.
And the Golden Knights as well, taking on the Jets tomorrow. So it all kind of, it's just grab a different dance partner and let's go again. Hey,
I probably look just like it, but Leonardo DiCaprio meme?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
That's exciting. Exciting times over there. And in the association last night, that Lakers-Bucks game was phenomenal. Double overtime, back and forth, no LeBron, Lakers on the road. We're down by a significant margin. I kind of was like, oh, they're just going to tuck this one away and play again tonight. But they didn't. They came storming back. Some of my expectations for Lakers may possibly be changing. I don't want to get into it too much because I know all of you hate the NBA. But I thought that was an interesting development last night.
Thunder 2, 20 down, topping New Orleans 119-112, a tight battle in the West there. A few good games last night. Raptors back in action tonight, looking to shake an 11-game streak.
Oh,
well,
that sucks.
We had the Porter story.
You black bastard! You little bastard! I said you desert me.
Hey, Wednesdays, we got 7 different Owen clips here for this day.
Owen! 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 Owen!
They sound the same. I love it.
The one I'm looking at, they all say Aaron.
Really?
Whoever put it together.
Who's in there with you?
Who's in there with you? Wednesdays. I saw some people texting in earlier, actually, some quotes from Throw Mama from the Trailer. It's really kind of warmed my heart on a few of them. Yeah, One-Eyed Pete is in and says, Evan doesn't have any friends. And Gordo is in and says, Evan, cut my toenails.
McClintock tweets at me, get off your fat little ass or I'll break it for you.
All right, it's a thing. I mean, it's a fun little thing. And we'll mess around with it a little bit for sure. Leon Draisaitl got him going last night, didn't he?
Try. Leon scored a goal tonight. Watching him play is quite a sight. You know this song is tight. Oilers fans, come on. You loved him endlessly since he was drafted number 3. He's a center with a size that was born in Cologne. Try to stop him, you can't do much more. That ain't no lie. You just wanna see him shoot and score. It was try. Gonna make a fool out of you. Probably score a goal and assist on two. You can't stop him and that ain't no lie. Cause it's try. Don't even try to play him rough. Leon is a German so you know he's tough. His hands are crazy and Aikens loves his eyes. Yeah, it's try. Gonna make a fool out of you. Probably score a goal and assist on two. You can't stop him and that ain't no lie. Cause it's try. Don't even try to play him rough. Leon is a German so you know he's tough. His hands are crazy and Aikens loves his eyes. Yeah, it's try.
Oh, Leon Draisaitl goal song for you. We got more where that came from. Those are for Sportball. Sign your kids up for the summer programs right now. www.sportball.ca.
Play it.
What's that?
Play it.
The Nuge? What? Play what?
The Pugliarvi song.
No, I can't do it.
Play it.
I can't do it. The only way I would play the Yes, the Pugliarvi song is if we are at like 100 likes by 7 o'clock. That's the only way. I don't even think people want it. But nice to see him score. Kind of got him going. That's
half hour.
I'm keeping track of first goals in games he scores for the Penguins. That's two.
What an analytic.
He starts well. That's it. Yeah. He starts well. The Oilers didn't start well last night.
They could use a guy.
We're going to get it. I'm not saying it. He said it. I didn't say it. I'm not saying it anymore. I'm done with this. I mean, deep down inside, I'm not done with it. But I've forced it down. Sure. I saw my therapist. I forced it down.
Yeah.
All right. We do have the morning after show for Amy Tillman locating on the way.
You're going to go to a chiropractor in like 3 years. He's going to crack something. You're going to start crying.
It's all my JP stress. Morning after show is on the way next. Ryan Nugent Hopkins gold song we have to get to. And I says pardon coming up for lawyer-central.com/pardons around 6:50 this morning. Keyword for Vegas in 50 minutes. Don't go anywhere. Tell your friends how easy it is to consume the wonderful content here at EdmontonSportsTalk.com. Let's get to a sports update for Green Plan with Lieutenant Eric.
Oilers back in the win column with a 4-3 victory over the Jets. Zach Hyman with the overtime winner, his 51st of the season. Leon Draisaitl, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, and Connor Brown also supplying the offense. Stuart Skinner stopping 22 of 25 shots faced. The Oilers are back home to host the Kings tomorrow night. Elsewhere, the Avalanche drop one of the visiting Habs 2-1, snapping Colorado's 9-game win streak. The Predators, they'd score 3 straight in the third, defeating Vegas in overtime 5-4. Nashville's point streak now sitting at 18 games. Capitals holding down the second wild card spot in the East following a 4-3 win over Detroit. Stars double up the Sharks 6-3. Over to the NBA, Austin Reeves with a triple-double, leading the Lakers in a double overtime win, 128-124 over the Bucks. Luka Doncic, 28 points. Mavs route the Kings 132-96, and the Thunder, they'd rally from 20 down to top the Pelicans, 119-112. 12 games around the NBA this evening, including the Raptors looking to shake an 11-game losing streak when they welcome in the New York Knicks. That's it for spring training baseball as the Jays, they'll get set to open the regular season tomorrow afternoon down in Tampa to begin a 4-game series. Sports update brought to you by Green Plan, providing you with award-winning environmental planning and consulting services. Whether it's municipal, industrial, or residential, plan it right with Green Plan. Visit green-plan.com. or give them a call, 780-455-4292.
There's something happening here. The Oilers look a lot better this year. Another win put 2 points on the board, telling me your faith is restored. I think it's time you stop, listen, here we go. Wake up with the morning after show. This year's team's looking strong. Connor and Leon, they can't do no wrong. 6 o'clockers are losing their minds. Getting so many messages on the text line. Think it's time you stop, listen, here we go. Wake up with the morning after show.
So I should not have access to a soundboard. It's just that right. My wife is right. It is stupid. But I love that soundboard, man. What am I supposed to do?
Don't stop.
Wednesdays right here on the Nielsen Show.
I mean, at least for the opening hour, right?
I would tell Matt today on the Hangout, be like, hey, man, you got to continue with Wednesdays. By the way, on the Hangout today, Dave Jameson and Evan Dahm, which is going to be a great Hangout today. Those two guys can put sentences together. Yeah, it's
and
very
a smile
exciting.
On your face as well,
Also, you are a bunch of sick puppies today, because we'll be like, hey, can you please give us a like? That would be great. It would really help the channel. And then I was like, we're not playing the Yes, Apply Arvey song unless we get to 100 likes by 7 o'clock. And it was almost like 100 likes instantly.
Not even the soccer threat, which leads me to believe more people would want soccer talk on this station as opposed to lack of Pull Your RV goal songs. The proof's in the pudding.
Look, we'll get to it. We are in the middle already of the EM utility locating morning after show, but I'll play it for you before 7 o'clock. Why not? It's a happy day.
It's a Wednesday.
It's a happy day. It's an O Wednesday.
You've heard, Tammy already said the show can get anywhere. What's Pull Your RV goal song?
You think that's stupid. What do you think about this? All right, let's get into it. It is the morning after show. For the award-winning EM Utility Locating, don't kill yourself. Call EM Utility Locating. Any job that you have that requires anything beneath the surface, give them a call. 780-222-9497. Check out their website, www.emutilitylocating.com. And April is Dig Safe Month, as opposed to digging unsafe the other 11 months of the year. But April is Dig Safe Month. And if you give them a call at 780-222-9497, they'll set up a free seminar, come by, show you some safety tips. They're not going to be like, and now pay for this course. It's a nice way to sort of just dabble in it a little bit. GPR and concrete scanning, damage prevention, planning, design, education, and training. I've already got, as I was watching the game last night, this is how much this EM Utility morning after just got in my head. I was like, that guy's going to be my steady Eddie of the evening.
And
we haven't even mentioned him yet. We're going to get to it as we work our way through the show. EST, big moment that happened last night. Rick, what are you going with?
Free Nuge, justice for Nuge, the penalty kill. End of the third to kind of, I mean, you're looking at that and you're saying, huh. And when you hear Jack Michael say, Knobloch's hot. I just kind of, oh, he's hot and down on the bench. Killing that Nuge penalty that maybe shouldn't have been. Friendly fire, I guess, is what they're calling the broadcast.
Next year, that's going to likely be reviewable, right? What's happening?
And that's
here.
What they were explaining. They're like, hey, we'd love to review it.
Yeah.
Or whatever the case was. I'm sure that's a tough explanation to a coach. But yeah, killing that and getting it to the extra frame. I know they had the 2-goal lead and everything, but certainly you're kind of like, huh. Nuge gets in the box or Pat. You could see Winnipeg, and then you're like, oh boy. And I was like, much like you're thinking of Steady Eddies, I'm thinking of the inbox tomorrow morning coming in here following a loss to the Jets.
The penalty kill was huge.
Penalty kill was huge, and that bleeds into my super stat of the night as well. But from my big moment, it's that Nuge kill.
That was a big one. I don't want to take anything away from the win because the win's a win, but they got to start locking some of these things down.
As a glass half full guy, and you're coming in here and about things they need to improve, for shame.
Do you not feel, and when they were on the winning streak, early Knobloch days, when they had a lead, even if it was just 1 goal, you're like, oh, this thing's locked down. Like, they were not blowing anything. It seemed like they'd finally got to a point where if the Edmonton Oilers had a lead in the third period, that thing was going to get sealed away. Teams weren't even going to have a sniff. Now you watch them and you're like, come playoff time, I'd be a little bit worried about this team with a lead in the third right now. I don't know why all of a sudden it's gotten back to this, but it has. As for my ESC big moment that happened, I know they did come back after this, but Draisaitl scores, and then not long after, Connor Brown buries one, and you're like, okay, you know, they're gonna put some pucks behind Hellebuck tonight. So I'm gonna go with Connor Brown's third of the year as the EST big moment. It was a nice goal, too. So good for Connor Brown. Yeah. Confidence level must be at an all-time high right now as far as his Oilers career goes. So we've got that going
One thing
for
to
us.
Get off the schneid, but to yeah. actually demonstrate what you should be known for.
I think we'll get to Connor Brown post-game, too, if you want to grab that, Trevor. I was watching last night. I know they had that. Super stat of the night, Rick. What are you going with?
Well, the PK answered the bell. Yeah, especially following, you know, Sundays, whatever you want to call it, down in Ottawa. Jets 0-4-5 with the man advantage, and Oilers just stretching more into the special teams numbers. 1-4-4 with the man advantage, and that was the Nuge goal to make it 3-1. But yeah, 0-4-5, and I'm staring right smack dab at that. I'm sure you can make a case for a few other numbers on the evening, but following Sunday's incident down in Ottawa, that's what I'm looking at for your super stat.
It's tough to not get away from that, simply because not only did they go 5-for-5, they looked good in doing it. There was the 4 minutes, not a shot on goal.
The 4 minute kill.
The big one late, obviously, as well. I don't know how the penalty kill can look the worst it's looked all season against Ottawa. And then last night, I'd argue that it kind of looked the best that it's looked all season.
And so, if you're really keeping score, Winnipeg does have a slightly better power play than the Senators, albeit
God, I
both,
would hope
both
you,
in the doldrums.
You have a better power play than the Sens.
Sure, but you wouldn't have known that Sunday, right?
Like, it's no, you wouldn't. Sunday, they look like
world beaters, eh?
Yeah, they looked unbelievable on Sunday. So outside of that, my super stat of the night.
51 for Hyman, you know? I don't know.
Yeah, 51 for Hyman's good. He had 6 shots on goal.
Especially after the whole video stuff yesterday. It was kind of
you know where I'll go? I'll give him a little bit of love here. Vander Kane had 6 shots on goal last night. And I don't know when the last time was Evander Kane had 6 shots on goal. I mean, I don't think it was recently.
How many went in?
Well, none. And he had some, but he had some really good
really
looks.
Well, the breakaway.
Really good. The breakaway.
Two of those shots were on that breakaway, and he got stoked twice.
Had a couple of other good looks, too. I thought that was one of his more active offensive games in quite some time.
He's trying. Didn't just Jerry, repurpose so. The Brown song for Evander Kane.
I'm trying. All right. 3 stars last night's hockey game, and then we'll get to your 4 star with Lieutenant Eric here. Sean Monahan was the first star of the game last night. All right.
Well, there were 2 different sets.
Like there's the Sportsnet Edmonton TV stars.
But never have they been so far apart.
These are the in-house stars. Yeah. Monahan, McDavid, and Brendan Dillon were the 3 stars last night at the game. Who's your 4th star of the game?
Pionk, Pionk, Pionk! 2 assists. Somebody on Twitter wanted me to do it today. Look, it's probably the last time, maybe your last time.
Can you imagine a playoff series?
I can.
Without a Pionks?
Yeah, but I'll give it to Pionk. 2 assists just for the bit.
38th star of the game last night. Tyler Toffoli played almost 16 minutes.
Who?
Zeros across the board. Exactly. Like, did you notice Tyler Toffoli last night?
Well, people noticed him before the game. There's a lot of talk about, you know, and the Oilers missing out. And here we are, zeros.
You noticed Kyle Connor.
Yeah.
You noticed Scheifele. You noticed Niederreiter last night. I thought Niederreiter might have been one of the best Winnipeg Jets last night. I did not really notice Tyler Toffoli at all last night. So I'll give Tyler Toffoli the 38th star of the game. The EM Utility locating Steady Eddie of the evening. www.emutilitylocating.com. Warren Fogle.
Oh.
I'm going okay. Warren Fogle on the EM Utility Locating Steady Eddie of the evening. I thought Fogle had an excellent game. Set up Draisaitl for the one look. I thought he was moving.
Excellent
I thought
for he was Steady Eddie.
Yeah I thought Fogle was good last night. I liked Fogle's game last night. I did.
You like him.
I like him. I like Fogle. I liked his game last night. So, let's go. Warren Fogle, your Steady Eddie of the evening. Connor Brown with his third of the campaign. Here's what he had to say to the media following the game.
Stick. He just ripped it out of my hands coming by the bench, actually. I didn't know what was going on there. And then he exchanged it back on the way out. It was a little too small for him in the slot, though. I think he would have buried one if he had his own.
You were on the bench, and he skated by and took it?
Yeah, I always had one leg over the boards, and he just ripped it out of my hands. Yeah.
It looked like you had one in your hands, and then he kind of threw it back at you, and then you kind of didn't know what to do with two sticks.
Yeah,
you go out and...
Yeah, well, I wanted my game stick back, so you know, I was changing for him, so I just took it back and threw my other one over the boards. Yeah, there you go. Exactly.
Connor, how does it feel to contribute in a big way in a big game? I mean, that was an entertaining hockey game against one of the league's best, and you get in the goal column today.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah, it was great. Nice pass by Ecky there. I thought our line was doing a lot of good things with the puck, and it's nice to get rewarded.
Who else but Hyman in the overtime? Hey, I mean, he always just seems to come up clutch for you guys.
He does, yeah. He's a big time player for us, and he shows up time and time again in big moments, and we're lucky to have him.
You're part of killing that penalty at the end. That was probably unjust. It would have been a lousy way to lose, but the fact that you guys killed the penalty makes it something we can talk about or joke about.
Yeah, I agree. I think we showed a lot of resolve. Kind of, you know, obviously we weren't happy with the call, and we, you know, I think we put it behind us and just got the job done. It shows a lot about the character of this group.
When you look at the standings, and I'm not saying that you did before the game, but it's nice to get at least a victory and a little bit more separation from teams that might be chasing you.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, it's, you know, we don't think we're done. We got a job to do in this regular season, and you know, it's one game at a time. And I think really liked our process in our game tonight.
Connor, when you surrender the 2-goal lead and it's 3-3 hockey game late again in the third period, what's the messaging on the bench?
I think it's just stay composed, back on the attack mode. I mean, just, you know, obviously this game's it's a game of momentum, and obviously, you know, they get one and then they get another one right away, and, you know, the momentum swung in their way, but I thought we did a good job of, you know, settling it down, staying composed on the bench, and just go back to doing what we do, and we came up with a win.
Browner? Do you want to score a goal, man? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you shoot the puck. You're out of luck, you should practice every day. You used to score like 20, and now you're not. I wish we could find out why. Do you want to score a goal, man? Doesn't need to be a hat trick.
I'm trying.
Tell me why.
It worked. It worked. The married couple. We played that, and Brown scored like less than 10 days later. And he's been lighting it up ever since. It is your EM Utility Locating morning after show, brought to you by EM Utility Locating. Don't kill yourself. Give them a call. 780-222-9497. Like, if you're like, I'm not going to go dig in my backyard, and you dig down, you're like, what is this? Then that's when you go. EM Utility Locating. Yeah,
stretch it out to April, hey? April 1st on Monday.
And then that's Dig Safe Month.
Get that Dig Safe Month.
That's it. By the way, how about the chin strap, boys?
Isn't it something?
This is thick. It's luscious.
Isn't it something?
I got a couple of chin strap boys.
I'm your triangle to your tuba here, I think, in that regard. You are the lead hand. Yeah. That is something else. No, you are
pretty good about last night. When I shaved it in, I was like, oh, this is good.
You were the mascot, yeah. And
pretty happy about it.
And as I usually say, a new baby Nielsen on the way.
Help us end the stigma. All right, look how good we look right now. You're telling me you can't do one of these all the time?
You don't got any gray in there, hey? Do you have any?
A little bit here, but that's about it. But yeah, for the most part, I'm a little baby boy. So that's exciting. All right, hey, we gotta keep rolling here because we haven't got to the Nuge song yet. And Nuge kind of off to Schneid himself. The Nuge can play once again, baby.
100 likes.
Yeah.
Can't grow a mustache because he's too young, but he's playing like a superstar. Oilers took him at number 93 on, and he's been great so far. No one was sure if he would make the team. Scott said his vision was the very best. Game-winning goals and 5-point nights. It sure looks like he passed the test. He's like 99 in a way. He rarely makes a mistake. He's on the right track, baby. Or the Nuge can play. Just make
dry? Not. Dry? Not.
All the Nuge can play, and play indeed. No posts last night. Posts be damned.
Yeah.
Puts one in the back of the net. Amishman 19 is in and says, Connor Brown is like an in-house trade deadline acquisition. Who's going to be the first member of the media that actually like legitimately sort of says that? It's like, Connor Brown was like a deadline day ad.
We've hit the high water mark of the show.
Oh, come on.
Waiting for that one.
Come on. All right, so we did hit 100
but
likes.
But it's a good point.
Yeah, well, I mean,
Who's next? Hey?
Yeah. Speaking of key mid-season ads, I did say if we got to 100 likes, play the Yes, Apply Arby song today.
Nielsen
always pays his debts, unless it's to Scott McCord for $40 in his March Madness bracket. It's almost a thing now where I don't want to pay him. 3 days in a row on the Bear, it's been like, where's the money, Nielsen?
I love how you work your way out of these commitments by saying, well, we've gone this long. Look, I paid my taxes this long. Why would I pay him now? It's kind of funny. We're doing this back and forth thing, you know? Yeah.
All right. Only because you got to 100 likes. And it's like 125. That's good. Bravo. You guys wanted it. You want it? We're here to deliver. This is not our show. It's your show. It's all of our shows. So I'll do it for you. I mean, I also like hearing it, so.
I love Jesse. He's always having fun.
Jesse was picked fourth. Yeah, we didn't think he'd be there at the time. Now we've watched him play. We know he'll be just fine. Jesse's got himself some skills. Should be on McDavid's line. And Akins would have loved his eyes. And McClellan loves that body. You just know it. And now he's holding both his arms way, way up high. No doubt about it, that was Jesse's goal. Nobody but Jesse's goal. How did he learn to finish like that? Let's start planning the parade. The Oilers finally decided to make some change. You know I feel so dirty when he starts playing cute. We complain about the Hall trade, but the point is probably moot. And Akins would have loved his eyes. And McClellan loves that body, you just know it. And now he's holding both his arms way, way up high. No doubt about it, that was Jesse's goal. Nobody but Jesse's goal.
Man, I wish it would have worked out better here. I love that song. Ah, damn. All your songs brought to you by Sportball. Sign your kids up today. I guess the race has already been won to the Brown deadline acquisition.
I didn't know.
Apparently Gregor tweeted it yesterday.
So
I would assume in jest. Like, that's in jest, right? That's got to be in jest. Doesn't matter. But feel like it hopefully was in jest. A guy doing what he was supposed to do in the regular season just because he starts doing it after trade deadline, he's all of a sudden, what did that come on.
Brilliance.
What are we doing here?
Masterful gambit.
Come on. That must have been a hilarious message that was sent out, I guess. No, it wasn't in jest, but whatever. All right, let's get into I Says Pardon. I Says Pardon is brought to you by lawyer-central.com/pardons. If you got yourself into a sticky situation at some point, let them get you out of it. lawyer-central.com/pardons or give them a call, 1-888-288-8177, 1-888-288-8177 for Lawyer Central. And they don't just do pardons. If you have any other legal issues that you've ran into, Lawyer Central can help you out there as well. Clean slate, affordable rate, 1-888-288-8177. We have to get to this Berkshire.
Play it.
Man.
Play the whole thing.
I'm not playing it at all.
200 likes.
When you you could get to 500 likes. I would not play this.
I did say though, if we doctor it up with a few Owen clips, that could maybe
if we were to play it and drop one of these over top of it, then yeah, maybe.
You little bastard! I said you deserved me.
Yeah, kind of.
You don't have a cousin Patty. Owen doesn't have a friend.
Yeah, that's this one.
Andrew doesn't have a friend.
What a weird thing to post.
Well, I don't know. You in today's day and age, when the name of the game is pissing people off and getting engagement.
Yeah, 5 million views.
Congrats to you, Andrew Berkshire, because you cracked the code there.
Yeah, but usually when you do something like that, you're going to get a bunch of follows. Because, like, or you do it to be like, I'm going to gain a bunch. But, you know, this guy's not going to gain followers from this. If you missed it, and I don't know how you would have missed it. 5 million views yesterday. But if you missed it, Andrew Berkshire, who used to be on Low Tide Show back in the day.
I used to phone him once a week, Habs Eyes on the Prize, blogger.
He's covered the National Hockey League. In the video, he said for 12 years. Awesome. Like, cool. I guess that means more.
Well, look, Ivan.
It seemed personal, right? Like, it seemed like a personal attack, like a grudge. Berkshire posted this video yesterday talking about how people need to stop with the narrative that Zach Hyman is a hard worker and he worked hard to get here because Zach Hyman's parents had a lot of money and Zach Hyman got more opportunity because his parents were rich than any other kids would have gotten. I mean, first of all, Berkshire, I don't know if you know this or not, but the majority of the guys in the National Hockey League probably come from pretty well-off families because hockey is not cheap. Especially nowadays, if you're like, you're going to play spring hockey and summer hockey, and you're going to be in this club, you're going to be in that club, you're going to be in this club. I didn't even buy into that part of it. And then he kept trying to come back around and be like, you can't take away 50 from him. But it's not just because of hard work. And we need to start, like, why is the narrative of people trying to say that Zach Hyman really did nothing at Michigan for a couple of years, worked at his craft, got better, got into the National Hockey League, worked at his craft, got better because of his hard work, and the way he plays was put in a spot to complement some really great players and has completely crushed it this season. It's not like he went from 10 goals to 50. He went from 10 to 15 to 21 to 27, 37 to 50 or whatever it was. It was very bizarre. The whole thing was bizarre. It seemed like Zach Hyman had personally hurt Berkshire at some point in his life. And Berkshire was like, enough is enough. I can't handle this narrative about this really nice guy. I don't know what this is. I watched it the whole time. And, you know, sometimes you can post a tweet and you'll be like, might not have been the best idea. It happens from time to time. But this was not, I'll just post this quick tweet, my quick thought. This is straight up a 4-minute video could have bailed on at any point when you're like, how are people going to view this? Like, did he honestly put it out and think people would be like, exactly. They're Andrew Berkshire gets it. Is that what you thought was going to happen here?
Well, it's like when somebody has a post that's like a novel and I too long didn't read, like too long didn't watch.
Yeah.
I almost, look. You know me. I'm not a black and white. I like to kind of I like to explore and give people. And again, online nowadays, you can't get into any sort of debate or back and forth with anybody. It's just you're an idiot and you're a loser and I hate you and go to hell. But 4 minutes is a little long. And when you're getting into that length, it gets into the deranged area. Again, making a point, having to backtrack and say, but I don't take anything from him, but, and then he goes on, and then he goes back, but I don't take anything from him, but, and he keeps, so, and again, all points that we kind of, look, did Zach Hyman get to 50 goals just by working hard? No. Like, that's not the only recipe in this cake. But I don't think any of us are sitting here being like, if I go out and just work hard, everything, that's not the case. There's also, but we know this. Again, it's not something that you have to compile a 4-minute video and explain it to us. I get that. It's not just hard work. But you don't have to like, why do you need to reshape the narrative of that? That's the good part of it. Why are you going to go into the part where like, see, if your parents are rich, you can't have 50 goals. There's nobody saying that. What? You can get 50 goals if your parents are poor. But it's not just the hard work. I think maybe that was the point he's trying to make. Obviously, it came across in a terrible. And again, 4 minutes. I'm sorry. If you're trying to make a point in these, like, you can't have a 4-minute diatribe on Twitter and then the words, you know, closed captioning for those. I don't know. It was a really weird, deranged thing. And again, it did seem personal. However, nothing really said in there was false. I mean, it's.
Yeah, his parents had lots of money, but like.
Yeah. But okay.
How many rich kids whose parents thought they were going to play in the show because they put them in hockey camps 365 days a year. How many rich kids didn't make it? You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't make sense to me that.
Oh, no. Like, yeah, I like, mean, not many, every rich how, kid how, makes how, it.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, but also to the point, like, it's just you can't just go out there with a lunch pail and be like, yeah, this is my path to success. There are other, there's lots of other factors. But again, him explaining, taking a 4-minute video to explain to us that we don't already know that, I don't have to watch that.
I would love to sit down and be like, why did you do this? Why does people giving credit to Zach Hyman, who comes across as a pretty good guy, why does that drive you crazy to the point that you're going to try to like strip him down? I don't understand it. It just never really made sense. And when I watched it yesterday, the first thing I thought was, I says, pardon? What is this about? What is this trying to be accomplished here?
Too long.
So I
who does 4-minute video? He's got to have a blue check, right? Because like, that's one of the,
yeah, in order to that's post one of the, longer the perks, than 220, right? I think.
No, he doesn't even have one.
Oh, how the hell did he post 4 minutes?
4-minute videos on Twitter? Are you kidding me?
Who's this?
Exactly.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Hey, that's the perfect clip. Andrew Berkshire.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Wednesday strikes again.
Andrew.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Oh, this one might work too.
Who are you talking to? Who's in there with you?
Oh, yeah. Who are you talking to? Who's in there with you?
Who is in there with him? 780-2899.
Somebody, yeah, I think Strummy.
I mean, look, he covers the Habs. Yeah. Hyman was a former Leaf. I mean,
he used to cover the Habs.
No, I know, but you know what I mean. It's kind of, maybe there's a connection there.
Weird day. Weird message. But we're moving past it.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
If you want to watch the 4-minute video, I think it's still online.
This is also me when I saw the Jonte Porter story.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Send us your who the hell are you all of a sudden. Actually, Connor Brown.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
That works out pretty well, too. 780-218-9999. Fun 6 o'clock hour. Cost for everybody.
Austin Reeves.
Yeah. 2 minutes left in the game. Austin Reeves with the logo 3.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
That's a great clip. All right, we got Craig Button on the other way. Us when Greg Wyshynski shows up via video today for the first time ever.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
All right, Craig Button's on the way. Keyword for Vegas in 20 minutes. Don't go anywhere. If you're listening on TuneIn or iHeart or AmateurSportsTalk.com, please tell your friends how easy it is to consume what we believe to be entertaining content. Let's get to a sports update with Lieutenant Eric this morning. Macramalla around 7:45. Keep those intros flying in as well.
Edmonton Oilers back in the win column last night with a 4-3 win over the Jets. Zach Hyman working hard, scoring the overtime winner, his 51st of the season. Leon Draisaitl, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, and Connor Brown also supplying the offense. Stuart Skinner stopping 22 of 25 shots faced. Oilers back home tomorrow night to host the Kings. Elsewhere last night, the Predators, they'd score 3 straight in the third, defeating Vegas in overtime 5-4. Nashville's point streak now sitting at a firm 18 games. Avalanche, they drop one at home to the Habs 2-1, snapping Colorado's 9-game winning streak. Capitals, they win a big one over Detroit 4-3, and the Stars double the Sharks 6-3. Over to the NBA, where the Lakers double overtime win over the Bucks 128-124. Austin Reeves with a triple-double. Luka Doncic had 28 as the Mavs would rout the Kings 132-96. And the Thunder rallying from 20 down on the road, topping the Pelicans 119-112. 12 games around the NBA later tonight, including the Raptors looking to shake an 11-game slide when they host the New York Knicks.
The Nielsen Show featuring Lieutenant Eric. Only on Edmonton Sports Talk.
It is the Nielsen Show. We're having some fun with the soundboard from Throw Mama from the Train today. And this text comes in. This is a good one from Honest Andy today. Shohei Ohtani to his interpreter.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
That's a good one.
This is a good, like, see, who said Wednesdays would be working here?
Hey, Wednesdays. Wednesdays is it's working out pretty good.
Top of the morning.
We do have Macramalla on the way to talk about the Ohtani situation. He's going to be by around 7:45. Free advice for Damon Bunting at 7:30 this morning. Keyword for Vegas coming up in 17 minutes. Text in that keyword, and you will go into the mix for the EST Flyway to Vegas. Two nonstop flights, three nights accommodations, tickets to a Cirque show, flexibility for booking. Going to be real nice, real nice. So we'll give you that keyword here in about 17 minutes. Greg Wyshynski around 8:30 this morning. And, of course, you can text us anytime in the Paris Jewelers inbox at 780-218-9999. We do have Craig Button joining us for Pro-Am Sports. They've got signings at a deadline today with Ethan Morrow. And then they've also got signings locked and loaded with Vincent Desharnais and Ryan Smith. More info on that at www.proamsports.ca. Let's bring in Craig Button this morning. Oilers and Jets living up to the hype yesterday, Craig. There's no doubt about that. That was a fun hockey game from start to finish.
Two teams that, you know, would come in a little bit wobbly, shall I say. And now you look at the Jets, they've lost four in a row. You know, the Oilers didn't want to get into that space. And after they blew the 3-1 lead, blew it. I mean, you got to give the other team credit. After they surrendered the 3-1 lead, you know, Hyman again, I mean, just an unbelievable play to win the game. But it is a good game by two really good teams. And certainly, you know, the questions will be asked in Winnipeg today and tomorrow because they got Vegas on Thursday. It doesn't get any easier now for the Winnipeg Jets. And, you know, we saw them last year run into this little – not a little, a big bump on the road. They want to make sure that this stays a little bump in the road because Nashville right now is hot on their heels, 4 points behind, and they play each other one more time.
Ooh.
Craig, I see you're in your Michigan yellow here. Zach Hyman, obviously a fellow alumnus of yours. I know we'll probably get back to the game.
Can we just stop right there, Lieutenant Eric?
What?
Like, we got to stop right there. Mays.
Maize and blue. Maize and blue. Maize and blue. Like, my bad. You don't want to be yellow. You're a national champion.
When you said stop right there, I was like, uh-oh. What's
he's
going to
talk about Hyman and his work ethic.
Yeah.
But we haven't talked to you since he hit 50. Your thoughts on Hyman, his work ethic, hitting 51 in overtime, given some of the videos out there on the internet that were circulating yesterday. Just your thoughts as a former Wolverine, him getting to this point.
You know, it's amazing. I've watched Zach play since he was 17 years of age, 16 years of age. And his progression, it took him time. It took him a lot of time to find his way. At the University of Michigan, it wasn't until the second half of his third year, his junior season, that he really started to show some offensive capabilities. The next year he was phenomenal as a senior and was a Hobie Baker finalist and certainly established a level of a standard of a game that was really quite impressive. And then what he ends up being able to do is just take that into the NHL. And to me, I'm seeing a very similar kind of progression. You know, first little stretch in the NHL, good player, you know, does a lot of positive things. Now he ends up in Edmonton, and certainly, you know, you look at what he's done since he got to Edmonton, he's been beyond terrific. And the 51 goals now, it's just another sign of somebody that continues to take his game up different levels. He's a great example of a player. You can keep growing in your game. We want players to do it at 22 and 24 right away. Sometimes it takes players a little bit longer. And certainly with Zach Hyman, what he's been able to do since he signed in Edmonton, it's not only impressive. The admiration that I think the Edmonton Oilers fans have for Zach Hyman, the way he plays the game, and you saw how humble he was after. It was just thanks.
After the goal.
thanks. And I think the appreciation that his teammates and everybody has for him is well deserved, and certainly an important player. It goes without saying, an important player for the Edmonton Oilers.
Craig, it's funny you bring up that time in Michigan, because when he got to 50, we were going through like his progression, and I said that morning, I was like, I have to know what happened between his third season and his fourth season in Michigan, because he just blew up. You said it kind of took midway through that third season, it kind of started to click. Was it his skating? Like, was it opportunity? How all of a sudden did he blow up on the scene in that fourth year in Michigan?
Well, I think it was all those things, Dustin. I think there was opportunity. I think it was maturity. I think he understood that, like, hey, I'm capable of doing more and on the offensive side of things. Whenever you watch Zach, there was never a lack of effort and determination, and that certainly is on display every single shift that he plays. But his confidence grew, and certainly given opportunity. And it's funny, I say this now because of the portal in the NCAA. He could be a player now that might leave after a second year and go somewhere else because he doesn't think that he's, that he might need another place. Him being able to stick it out in Michigan, I think was a real springboard for the success that he's had now in the NHL.
NHL analyst Craig Button with us on the show this morning. As far as that game goes last night, you did mention give Winnipeg some credit. The Oilers were up 3-1 with 13 minutes left to go and had to end up winning it in overtime. So maybe some positives to take away from this game for the Jets. But where do you think that Winnipeg team is at right now? And like I said this morning we were breaking down the show in the 6 o'clock hour. Tyler Toffoli was kind of unnoticeable last night. And I know he's been great since they added him. So where's things at right now with the Jets?
Well, I think there's got to be concern. Listen, just give me one second, guys. I just got to answer my door.
Okay. Oh, he actually is going. Exciting. He's going to answer his door.
The DoorDash, hey? A little brekkie.
I love it. I hope it's breakfast. That's great. I thought Craig was doing a joke, and then he left and came back. All right, Craig Button will be back. But I'm interested to see where the Winnipeg Jets are at right now. Like, today on the Lock Shot, but it'd be great with Huss. Huss was at the game last night. He was already talking about, now, the Jets, I thought, played better last night. And they had all come out and had a great start.
Well, and Bones was back, too. Bones was absent for a couple of games.
They moved some things around, obviously. But compared to what the Jets had done out on the road trip, last night's game was pretty good from the Winnipeg Jets. They clawed back into it. They got a point out of a game in which they were kind of desperate to get a point right now. So I thought that was big for the Winnipeg Jets.
But I mean, that's,
and they had that great start.
But it's your neighbors right now, though, right? The Stars and the Avs, and you got to be tight in that div. But then you got the Predators knocking on the door right behind you. It's
Barry the Cheater in the nasty chat.
What's
says,
Craig signing up for right
guys,
now? Eh?
Like, this is how horror movie starts. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna guess. I'm gonna guess it was somebody coming by. Like, man, it's 7:10 in the morning. I was gonna say maybe it was somebody coming by to try to sell him solar paneling. For
I'm gonna
roof.
Say an arborist. Do you need your trees trimmed?
Let's bring Craig Button. Craig Button back in here. Craig, who was trying to sell you something? What's going on?
I'm in Denver. Excuse me. I'm in Denver. I was in the Montreal. Oh, I was doing the Denver, the Colorado, Montreal game with somebody at my hotel door. Sorry about that. Now I got a frog in my throat. Holy jeez.
What a day. Right. What a day. No, we were talking just about Winnipeg and where they're at right now. Like, Dallas has separated themselves a bit from Winnipeg, not Colorado, and Nashville's kind of knocking on the door here. So what do you expect from Winnipeg down the stretch?
Yeah, and that's the thing right now. You know, it was a good game last night. They got to feel good about getting 1 point. But now the road ahead is not going to be easy for the Winnipeg Jets. And what I see in the Jets is when they play a game that where they really commit to a strong defensive effort, I'm talking about committing, they're a team that's almost unbeatable. But they get away from it. And it was the same thing that I saw last year. They get away from it for 10 minutes, and it was enough to hurt them. And this year, they've been one of the best defensive teams in the league. And like I said, when they're committed to that defensive team, they're almost unbeatable. But when they get away from it and they start to, drift a little bit and not really dig in, and that's what playoff hockey is about. It's about digging in and really saying, I'm going to win this battle. I'm going to win this puck fight. I'm going to be in the right position. Somebody's not going to get an edge on me. They slip for stretches, and it just seems those stretches really hurt them. They were playing the Islanders on Saturday, I believe. They got obliterated. But they're pushing the game. They're pushing the game. All of a sudden, Cal Clutterbuck scores on a faceoff. And then it went downhill from there for about the next 10 minutes. And then they play, but it was too late. And that's what they have to guard against. And when you have a Vegas team that blew a 3-goal lead against Nashville, they're not coming into Winnipeg with any other idea than to try to end their own hurt. So it's going to be challenging, but I think it's just digging in hard like they do when they have success on the defensive side.
Well, Craig, and just going on this theme from the Jets to the Preds, and if I didn't know my college sports, seeing you in that yellow shirt, I would have thought maybe that yeah. you're a Preds fan or something like that. I mean, what they did last night, I mean, that game against Vegas, you know, the storylines and everything coming from behind, extending that point streak, are they going to lose again? Like, what? Give me your thoughts on the Preds heading into this stretch run, and how noisy can they be in a postseason?
I think really noisy. And when you look at their team, you know, you watch the Washington Capitals right now. Goaltending has been outstanding. The power play has been really good. You know, obviously, when Ovechkin starts to heat up, that's going to give you a little bit more opportunity to win games. But when the Nashville Predators, you look at every single area of the game, everything, goaltending, defense, offense, power play, penalty killing, everything has been outstanding. So there's no area of their game where they're trying to have it propped up from some other area of their game. I said yesterday on Vancouver, I think it was Vancouver radio, if Vancouver was going to play Nashville if the playoffs began yesterday, I would pick Nashville yesterday to beat Vancouver. I think that they could be this year's Florida.
Wow. So you don't want to play them along the way with the way that it's kind of coming together. Well, we talked about Nashville a little bit earlier because they have a franchise goaltender and they have a franchise defenseman. And I mean, if you got those two pieces, Craig, that can carry you a long way with Roman Josi and Juuse Saros.
Yeah, Phil Forsberg's having a fantastic
great year,
season.
40 now, yeah.
You know, Gus Nyquist has gone in there and been a really good player. I also believe, too, that Barry Trotz went in there and really established a standard, a high bar, and Andrews held up. We all know the story now about the U2 trip being canceled and, you know, after they'd lost 9-2 at home to the Dallas Stars. But it started long before then. That was the one that where Andrew Brunette said, you know, there's no rewards for not digging in and playing hard and being competitive in games. There's no rewards for that. And he's right. But Barry Trotz last summer, he bought out Matt Duchene. He traded Ryan Johansson. And he just said, you guys don't help us win. And, you know, you're not going to be players. And I think that message that he sent that like high price players not good enough for us, and he needed the support of his ownership, make no mistake about it, but everybody looks around and sees that and goes, okay, this guy's serious. And he was serious, and something that I think really established a real mindset in Nashville that's helped them to this point.
Craig, before I let you go, you mentioned you're in Denver. What the heck happened last night? Colorado's been so good at home, and Montreal Canadiens end up delivering the dub last night.
43 seconds in, McKinnon extends the home streak, and it's like, uh-oh, here yeah. we go. You know, Montreal played a really good game in Seattle on Sunday, and you're thinking but they score 9 seconds later to make it 1-1. And Montreal, like the game last week in Edmonton, Montreal did not give up the middle of the ice to the Colorado Avalanche. They did not let the Avs speed, just like they didn't let the Oilers speed, really overwhelmed them through the middle of the ice. Everything was outside. Montembeau was outstanding, really clean in the net, tidy, no rebounds. And then they had some good penalty killing. Their penalty killing, I think, is 16 out of 17 now, or they're 15 out of 16 in their last 16 attempts. So you get good goaltending. You don't let the team freewheel, and that team and the team here in Colorado can freewheel as good as anybody. Montreal was full marks, and Eustace Annunen, like, he played really well. Montreal had a lot of really good chances. He played really well for the Avs, but the Avs just couldn't muster up. They had three straight power plays in the game. They had one shot total, and that's Makar, Toews, Rantanen, McKinnon, Drouin. It's a pretty good group of five they throw out there. One shot in three consecutive power plays.
Craig, as always, man, we appreciate the time. Safe travels wherever you're heading next.
I'm heading back to Alberta.
All right. Well, safe travels coming home, man. We'll talk to you next week.
Thanks.
There you go. That is Craig Button, interrupted by somebody at his hotel room door. How rude. That's good. Actually, somebody did text in when that happened and said, Craig Button, when somebody knocked on his door.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Can you imagine he says that line for
who the hell are you all of a sudden? That's too good. I like that. Keep those text messages flying in here at 780-218 780-218-9999. Yeah, I don't know what the deal is here with this Eustace Annunen, who's the goaltender for Colorado last night. He has now, he's 5-3-1. They don't play him a ton, but he's got a 926 goals against average and a 2.34 save percentage.
Play the clip.
Yeah. Eustace. This is working well for a lot of guys today.
Good today, yeah.
Eustace Annunen.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Anyway, his numbers, like Georgiev, 903 and a 2.80, but they've only played a new, it seems like every time I look at them on the lock shop, they're starting this guy, but he's only played nine times, but he's got a 926 save percentage. So I wonder if Georgiev struggles at all in the playoffs, if they're willing to go to this dude, because they haven't played him a lot. Georgiev plays a ton for the Colorado Avalanche, but the other kid's got some pretty good numbers. Something to keep in mind as we continue to work our way through the show today. A couple other text messages that rolled in. The Nashville Predators right now.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Well, no doubt.
Well, not all
these guys
18,
cannot lose.
This is 18 games.
This is an excellent run.
I think we know.
Do we know who the Preds are now? Is it 18?
18 straight.
Are they 16-0-2 in their last 18?
18 game points.
Oh, man, I thought it was 15-0-2. Jeez, this is even more impressive than I thought just moments ago. All right, 780-218-9999. You can chime in there in the Paris Jewelers inbox. We're coming at you from the Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen Studios this morning, where if you want to get that new flounder sandwich, I know some of you are thinking right now, I'd be crazy to go to a place that has delicious chicken like Popeye's and not have chicken and have fish instead. But here we are. Lieutenant Eric has given it his seal of approval. Anybody who's tried it has backed that up as well. It is the flounder sandwich, available until the 31st. You want to hop on this thing right away. Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen. Chicken and fish.
Flounder.
Flounder. What is fish, right?
Excellent.
Excellent flounder, he says. PT Mark's already in and says, what about useless Annunen? Feels like a pretty good chirp come playoff time. Well, let's see how it plays out. You don't want that one to come back around and backfire on you.
Hear a crowd chanting that one, hey?
That would not be good. All right, let's get to your keyword for the EST Flyway to Vegas. If you're watching on YouTube, remember you have to text this word in. If you're listening on iHeart or on TuneIn or at EdmontonSportsTalk.com, you can text in and tell your friends about how convenient it is to listen. Static, free, and entertaining every day of the week. Listen for the keyword four times per day right here on Edmonton Sports Talk. Again, on the hangout today with Dave Jamieson and Evan Dom. That's exciting. That's going to be a great hangout. On the lock shop with myself and Huss and Pat Gregoire. P. Gregg's going to pop by. We'll be talking a little bit of golf today. Just two games in the NHL tonight. One game on Friday. Great scheduling. But four chances to qualify every single day right here on Edmonton Sports Talk. Two nonstop flights, three nights accommodations, tickets to a Cirque show. Presented by Fly YEG and the LVCVA. Nonstop flights to well over 50 destinations. Your sports trip starts with a nonstop flight from Fly YEG. Visit www.flyyeg.com for more information. And when you book trips or you're at the airport, make sure you hit us up on social media so we can share it out to the world. All right, your keyword today is...
So,
well, Maddie, I said to Maddie yesterday.
Does he text him to you now?
I said to him, I said, listen, man. I said,
it just can't go
on. The keywords are missing. And he said he's going to print off new ones for next week anyway, like a new run. He goes, so I'll get you.
He's got the key.
But I think we're glossing over the fact that somebody has the keywords. It doesn't really change
the master
anything,
sheet, yeah.
No.
But an inside job, though. They haven't left this office.
It has to be Zacticum. It has to be Zacticum. It's in the report. Stole keywords. Today's keyword is buffet. B-U-F-F. E-T, as in, if you're really hungry and want a lot of food at a very moderate price, hit up a buffet. B-U-F-F-E-T. Text buffet to 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. Buffet is your keyword today. B-U-F-F-E-T.
Jimmy.
Nope, don't get that. People be confused. Whatever. Buffet. We didn't hit up a buffet when we were in Vegas.
No.
I wanted to.
You and I went that first time. We had a breakfast one.
When we went to Vegas.
To which I drank like liters and liters and liters of orange juice and the Prosecco or whatever it is. I mean, the buffets are good. They're great down there. Hey, you would say?
If you want to eat a Vegas buffet, a reasonable price, man, you can go hit the buffet. What was the one that we went to last time?
It was good. It was really good.
It was the MGM buffet just down in the corner on the right there. Good buffet. And everything, like breakfast, lunch, dinner, all there at the same time. It's like the buffet I went to here in town, the fancy buffet that Tam and I went to that one morning. And there was fish and everything for breakfast. She had sushi for breakfast at a buffet, if you can believe it. And you know a buffet is legit if it has an omelet station. Is that not the difference between like a good buffet and a great buffet?
Well, we were talking yesterday about washrooms too, and the attendants. You get a little guy there in a chef's hat. Yeah. What would you like in your omelet, sir? And
I hype up the omelet station, but I've never used the omelet station at a buffet.
You've never gone up and requested.
I've never gone up and requested an omelet because I go up and be like, just get cheese and ham, please? And they're gonna look at me and be like, this is the lamest omelet I've ever seen in my life.
And where are your parents, sir?
yeah, pretty much. A buffet is your key word today. B-U-F-F-E-T. We are going to get to your cool bet hotline of the day. But for all of you listening in the 7 o'clock hour who might have missed things in the 6 o'clock hour this morning, shall we hit the Connor Brown goal song one more time? And as somebody in the nasty chat pointed out, like the other two Connor Brown goals were in blowouts. Game was over. Decisions had been made.
Well,
This one was a big goal.
Getting off the schneid with an empty net or a skate deflect. Like, you know, you're off the schneid, but a true snipe, right?
A big goal in a big game and a nice goal to boot. Connor Brown, off the schneid song, hits again.
I think we're gonna be glad. I think it's today, yeah. Connor Brown scored last night, his dragon is slain. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. He's had chances galore, 2-1s and breakaways, yeah. Score, even strength of power play. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. He got to play McDavid live. He should've scored one, he should've scored twice by now. Got to play alongside Dry. How could he not score? How could he not score? How? He's played on every line, but he's best on PK. Yeah. He can never find the twine till he found his last game. Yeah. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time.
Connor Brown starting to contribute on a regular basis. I see some of your questions rolling in about Connor Brown. I'm going to save one of those for three questions too many coming up a little bit later on this morning. That'll be happening for Park Mazda just after 8 o'clock today. Probably have time to fit in at least one more goal song in the second hour of the show. We got the Nuge can play. We got Dreisaitl. We got Hyman, obviously. We can certainly hit on that if you have any suggestions. Nasty chat or in the inbox as it recovers from the pounding that it just took with the key word. Let's do our cool bet hotline of the day, Trev, and then call that qualifier, and we'll get them locked and loaded. Cool bet hotline of the day yesterday. What did I say? Take the easy play. Take the easy money. Connor McDavid over 1.5 points. Cha-ching!
Come on.
We got if they keep dropping this number at minus 118, minus 120, up to like minus 125, we have to ride with that on a consistent basis. So, yes, I liked cashing that one yesterday. Hopefully some of you cashed some tickets on that last night. And we've been on a pretty good stretch. Two misses over like the last 2.5 weeks.
Winning percentage is still, you're charting, man.
It's big. I'd get the start.
Yeah.
I'd get the start between the pipes with the winning percentage that I'm rolling out there right now. Not a lot to choose from tonight in the National Hockey League. Ottawa Senators, Buffalo Sabres, Boston Bruins, Tampa Bay Lightning. That's it. That's all. Two games tonight in the National Hockey League.
The appetizer for your Thursday, though.
Huge Thursday. Massive Thursday.
We talked Oilers, Kings, but Jets at home to the Golden Knights, too. Avs at home to the Rangers. Like, Feast, Vancouver at home to Dallas.
Oh!
You want more? This is the Vince McMahon thing.
What a Thursday night slate.
Leafs and Capitals from Toronto.
Oh, what a slate. What a slate. All right, see, Boston-Tampa tonight. Did we get on this game tonight? Boston played in Florida last night, won. Do we look at Tampa tonight? You know, man. I say we do this.
Busy night around the NBA.
I think we follow. Yeah. I think we follow up the McDavid over 1.5 points play with a Kucherov over 1.5 points play. I mean, somebody texted in, how many assists does Kucherov have right now? Because somebody said, you know, McDavid's going to get to 100 assists. Mm-hmm. But there's a chance, like an outside shot here, that Kucherov could get to 100. He's at 82. He'd have to get hot. McDavid's at 93. It's happening. But Kucherov being at 82 assists, too, very impressive. So let's go with this. Kucherov, over 1.5 points tonight, following up on the heels of McDavid delivering for us. Kucherov over 1.5 points tonight, plus 118. And when it's a McDavid number, it's minus 118. For Kucherov, you can actually turn around some plus money on it. So Kucherov, plus 118 against the Boston Bruins. Bruins on the second half of a back-to-back after picking up a big win against the Panthers in Florida, 4-3 last night. Guys, there needs to be a McDavid assist song that gets played when he hits 100. Connor Appleseed, make it happen. He's getting there. It's not even like... Anytime somebody puts something up, I'm going to be like, how impressive would it be if McDavid's not only getting 100 assists, he's blowing it out of the water. Like, he needs 7 assists in 12 games. At his current rate, he's going to get like 16 to 18 assists in those 12 games. So he's not only hitting 100, I don't think it's out of the question that he takes a run at 110. You can go ahead and call me like Oilers homer, but you don't think McDavid can get 17 assists in 12 games? I says pardon? Of course he can. So he's going to torch 100 assists.
He will.
It's an automatic. All right, let's get into our keyword for the EST Flyaway to Vegas, our qualifier. Trev, who do we have today, YouTube Trev?
We've got Dion.
Dion.
Yeah.
All right, let's go to Dion. Dion, congratulations, buddy. You are one step closer to winning a trip down to Vegas with FlyYEG.
If only you could see my eyes right now.
Ah, excellent reference. I love that. Who would you bring with you?
I'm going to put that up for auction. You know, we'll see.
Make some money off of this. It's a good idea. Have you been to Vegas before, Dion?
Once.
How long ago?
That was a long time ago.
Okay.
Too long ago.
Things have changed, and Dion is ready to go back to Sin City.
I'm ready.
All right.
Go tomorrow.
Best of luck, man. One step closer. Good luck in the grand prize draw.
Thanks, guys.
All right, there you go. Dion.
I like to just putting it out there. Come and get it.
Straight up auction.
I'm going to Vegas. Want to come with?
Who's that other guy who qualified last week, I think? Was it last week or earlier this week? Who's like, I think I might just go by myself. I don't know if that was on this show or one of the other shows, but he went to Vegas by himself before. It was on Oil Stream, I think, because Tommy said that he's done the solo trip. It was on Oil Stream when we were at Beaumont Boston Pizza. And the guy's just like, I think I might just go by myself. And you'd have two seats. So you know how much room you'd have? There'd be a very comfortable trip down.
Wonder, too, you kind of tag team somebody who's qualified last week. You can kind of come on and say, hey, you know, if I qualify, just boosting your odds a bit more. It's a strategy, you know, in the game.
This is why it pays off to have friends.
Yeah.
If possible. All right, let's get to a sports update for Park Mazda. Free advice on the other side. What do you need help with? We're here for you, just like Damon Bunting is here for you from a real estate perspective. Buying or selling, he's your guy. He's our guy. But what do you need help with? 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. No charge. Free advice coming up next. Sports update with LTE right now.
Edmonton Oilers back in the win column with a 4-3 overtime victory over the Jets down in Winnipeg. Zach Hyman, his 51st of the season. Leon Draisaitl, RNH, and Connor Brown also supplying the offense. Stuart Skinner stopping 22 of 25 shots faced. Oilers are back home to host the Kings tomorrow night. Nashville's point streak extended to 18 games last night. They'd score three straight in the third, defeating Vegas in overtime 5-4. Avalanche drop one to the visiting Habs 2-1, snapping Colorado's 9-game win streak. Capitals 4-3 over Detroit, and the Stars doubling up the Sharks 6-3. Over to the NBA, where the Lakers winning in double overtime over the Bucks 128-124. Austin Reaves with a triple-double. Thunder rallying from 20 down on the road, topping the Pelicans 119-112. 12 games around the NBA tonight, including the Raptors looking to snap an 11-game slide when they host the New York Knicks. Sports update brought to you by the great staff at Park Mazda and Mitch Lubicki. He only hires hard workers for their dealership.
If you're like me, you like to picture yourself in luxury, even though there's absolutely no way you could afford it. And if you can, well, even better. Thankfully, I picture myself in something that is luxury, but still absolutely affordable, like the all-new Mazda CX-90 from Park Mazda. With the new luxury features like facial recognition settings and quilted detail Napa leather seating, I can pretend to be comfortable with all of my proper settings activated without even touching a button, thanks to Mitch Lewicki and the great staff at Park Mazda. I like to picture Mitch Lewicki as newborn 8-pound, 6-ounce Mitch Lewicki. You can picture grown-up Mitch, or teenage Mitch, or bearded Mitch, or whoever you want.
Park Mazda, your dealer for life in Sherwood Park off Y Road, parkmazda.ca.
Sorry, boys.
Hey everyone, I'm Zach Hyman of the Edmonton Oilers.
She's so tenacious.
Hope you guys enjoy it.
Revving up his engine, listen to the crowd just roar. No reason for tension, Zach is gonna shoot and score. Hyman's in the scoring zone. Right into the scoring zone. Signed for 7 years, now he's playing by McDavid's side. He's got you jumping out of your seat cause of that look in his eyes. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone. You know he's gonna score a few. Playing with Connor, it's a top line overload. You'll finally see what he can do. So raise your hands up as high as they can go.
You did it, didn't you, Owen?
He always said that was a magician's secret.
His energy is contagious.
Playing with an edge, that's what you're gonna see. Taking the next step, cause he's no longer with the Leafs. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone. Zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone.
Oh, 736, Zach Hyman in the scoring zone. I just had to give somebody
Yelling and the growling.
I just had to give somebody a 24-hour timeout in the nasty chat.
You did it. Hey,
oh, the guys who are taking a shot at Stoss' physical appearance. Like, if you want to criticize, and they're like, well, we can't criticize the media? Listen, man.
Well, and you warned. You gave a yellow card.
I gave a warning.
He two
came back,
that
came back
red,
with a jerk move.
Blue card.
And you are out of here.
It's do it. Yeah, give us
you
that.
You are out of here. That's what happened.
Yeah, I want you to ban more people from or
well, no,
more
like,
I, not ban. It's not a full banishment. But I want more of this just for your baseball outs. I really.
You little bastard! I said you desert me.
Yeah, I look. I've banned people before watching like the post game show, and you know, but don't get into like personal shots. You want to criticize the work that we do. You want to criticize, you know, people, the questions people ask. You want to criticize the play-by-play guys. You want to criticize work and takes. That's fine. You get into personal shots and people's appearances and stuff like that. It's absolute. Very close to swearing.
Yeah,
I'm not going to. It's complete BS, and I'm not going to stand for it in the nasty chat. It's that simple.
Anything going on online or on the nasty chat or anything, I think we can come together and have good conversations and stuff. But once it gets into those personal shots and then that we don't need that. A yellow card. Good on you for the disciplinary, Dusty. That's start calling you Surveyor
hey,
Brett.
Who am I?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I need today.
You need a sheriff's badge.
Right? I need this. I found it. I knew it was in my bag still. This is what I need right here, boys. A little cigar. A little cigar for the band, a 24-hour band. What do you think about that?
Plastic on.
What about plastic on? Well, I don't want to waste these bad boys.
Yeah.
I don't need my slobber all over these
now,
things.
I don't know.
Somebody brought these to me, and I've had them in my
two
bag
in a
ever
plastic
since.
Bag. Yeah,
two, but they're nice ones. These are nice cigars.
Not Dutch Masters.
No, these aren't Dutch Masters. These are Grand Cru Davidoff. And look, it's got a humidity pack inside this plastic bag.
Who needs a humidor? That's your humidor.
This is my humidor right here. So anyway, I'm going to put these cigars right here just in case, you know, I need to...
Well, fire one up one of these.
Pulling up at some point. Oh, JCD780 says, am I banned? Can you see this? No, you're good, man. You're good.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Scott the Chiefs fan. You just made the list, hey?
Yeah, that's exactly. Well, I don't know if I've ever seen this Wreckage 504 guy in the chat before anyway. So when I first saw him this morning, I was like,
who the hell are you all of a sudden?
All right, let's get into free advice for Damon Bunting. If you want to do business with a nice man, I think that's one of the biggest selling points. Do business with good people. Damon Bunting's one of those people. Visit his website, www.damonbunting.com. You can also find him over on Instagram. Another place he listed, I think, on Instagram yesterday.
He's good on the gram.
Damon Bunting Real Estate. He gets the gram.
He gets the gram.
He understands the gram way more than I understand the gram.
He's an adult, but he still understands the trends and everything that's making the making the scene nowadays. And who knows? You deal with him and he might become a friend of yours.
He's
type of guy that you could...
Yes.
Yeah, I could see a business relationship blossoming and developing into some sort of a personal one. Not saying it's guaranteed, but...
He's
the type of guy that could get you there.
He's one of the best people you can do business with, and he's one of the best in the business at what he does, which works out really well. He's one of the leaders in Western Canada with RE/MAX. That's why they call him elite. All right, let's get into free advice. What do you need help with? 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. 780-218-99. For the free advice... Boys, I'm recently divorced after a 10-year marriage. How do I get back into the dating scene? A lot has changed, apparently. Whew, I mean,
think we have somebody in the room right now.
I think it's different because Trev, like this guy's coming out of a 10-year marriage.
But that's what I'm saying. The game has changed.
The game has changed.
I talk to YouTube Trev some days.
But the game is the only game that he knows is the game that he's in now.
Sure.
Like, but he wouldn't know you want to go
to
game.
Well, but he does. Do we need to know what happened in the past?
Well,
this guy's looking
know.
Towards the future.
Trev, can you only meet people on the internet nowadays? Is that how it works?
That's definitely, I'd say
would you
the
say
majority.
Like 80% of the chance?
Yeah,
like?
Yeah. But, you know, I saw it a lot when I first got here bartending. You know, there's the odd, go to a bar and I've seen it happen quite a bit. So if you're smooth.
Just sit at
you
the
see,
bar.
Yeah, you see a nice lady. Go talk to them. And girls like that. Girls like that. I think they like that more than the I really do the online stuff like the Tinder, you know, the Bumble.
Tommy Gazzola when we need
him? Yeah, this is a great question for Tommy. But
I think Tommy does most of his work online.
Most of his work.
From a relationship status, most of his stuff's done online.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like I met my wife at a pub in Fort McMurray. So I would, I mean, I'd throw this out of this guy. I'd say get back out and about.
Yeah, I think that's the best. Get back out and about. Go out.
Yeah. Like, does anybody go to a coffee shop now and see, like, a cute girl or guy in line and be like, oh, man, I'm gonna ask them for their number. Like, no, what happens now is you try to get their name on their Starbucks cup and then search Steven or Sarah on all these social media apps, search through 1,000 people until you find it, when you could just step up, have a pair, and be like, hey, I wouldn't mind buying that coffee for you, you know? I don't know. Best of luck, man. I don't know. I can't give you advice on this. I met my wife just like Facebook poking was around then. There was nothing else.
I thought you'd get to the poking. You find their name on the Starbucks cup, you search them up on Facebook, just to poke, and then you sit back with your cigar, and you just
that's what happened.
First shot, Cupid's arrow.
So I met her that night, I think got her phone number that night, then did get on Facebook and poke her, and be like,
Well, that's, you do your further research off of there, but your initial...
Then she messaged me back, and I was like... if you're accomplished, you know, it was real good. So I don't know if we helped you with this advice, but if you need advice, 780-218-9999.
We were having a house party, and that's where my wife
is. That way,
the
house party,
yeah,
actually, mutual friends type of thing.
Yeah, when I met her physically, but I grew up listening to her on the radio. Ain't that something?
That is kind of weird.
Still,
too.
It's one of those
that's a dream come
where
true.
You've met somebody before you know them in real life, but I mean. Whether it's sitting at the bar,
yeah,
going out.
Just go talk to somebody.
The house party, for crying out loud.
Oh, man.
The people you'd meet at a house party.
Do you know how many girls
anymore?
I met at house parties that I wanted to marry? So many. You could do that. So good luck, man. I mean, look, listen. You already got married once. Just do whatever you did then again.
Okay, yeah.
I mean,
that's not actually
something that's more sustainable, I guess. Yeah. This text in and says, guys, I met my wife at an Oilers game.
Well, how does that, nice. Walking in the concourse, seated beside, I need more
details. I'm going to respond. Probably mingling in an intermission.
Details.
Having a drink.
This. But that's where the story is. That's where, like, you're getting married, and you're like, you know how we met? And then you have this big, long, game, but it was, you know, I dropped my popcorn. I don't know. All of these details that come through those stories, as assumed from, I logged on today and...
How Tube Socks has a great
right
story.
Or left.
I met my wife after her roommate took me home from a gig. Future wife was her roommate. Classic. What are the odds of that? That's like in Suits, briefly. But that's all I can think of.
You're a time traveling
roommate,
guy.
Roommate
though,
switch.
That's, things can change pretty quickly, though.
I guess they can.
Tube Socks, maybe isn't even Tube Socks today. If that.
All right, let's get to this one. 780-218-9999. Guys, I've got a condo that I'm ready to sell. Any advice on who I should deal with? Damon Bunting. Is this some sort of hilarious joke? You have a condo to sell? Damon Bunting.
And then Trev will buy it.
www.damonbunting.com and have them in touch. Whoever buys it, Trev will rent it from them. That's it. Dusty, would you trade Bijan Robinson for Christian McCaffrey in a dynasty league? Woo! I have started listening to fantasy football podcasts again, boys. I'm getting back in the swing of things. If you don't have a team that you think is going to win in the next year or two, I'd probably take Bijan Robinson and hope he becomes what everybody's expecting him to be. Guys, I've been betting just a dollar or two on Cool Bet, but I've been winning. Should I up the stakes a bit? As we say with our partners at Cool Bet, stay cool, bet responsibly. And if you get caught, have an interpreter that'll take the fall for you. So you might, up it to $3 and $5 if you've got the bankroll, but don't bet with outside of your means. Just don't do it.
So, more details on the met my wife at an Oilers game. She was a Canucks fan, and she was at the bar in the main... So, is this what I'm saying?
So, it was a bar.
You're
and-
like, oh, you sit next to her. She was a Canucks fan. She's the enemy. I want more details here. How did you get talking? Like, this is great. These are the stories you need. To hell with the online.
I met my wife at work from Lucas.
You remember that, eh?
I remember that. We were around then, right?
Yeah.
Guys, mixed sports like slow pitch are a great way to meet people. A few females are mandatory, so it only makes sense, really.
And we do have, another...
Yeah, Trev, you're playing co-ed sports, are you not?
Yeah, you know what? I am, actually. That's a good idea. There's some cute ladies in there, so I like that.
You're like, oh,
yeah.
People are having fun.
Yeah.
That's a really good one, yeah.
All right, let's go with this one. Guys, we're debating right now in our fantasy league if McDavid's goals and assists should be drafted separately in hockey pools next year, a la Gretzky back in the day. No. No. I mean, if you look at the numbers, what are you going to do the same with Kucherov? You're going to do the same with McKinnon? If McDavid was like at 160-point pace this year and he was going to have 60 goals and 100 assists, then yeah, maybe. Maybe I'd consider it. But I don't think anything from this season should lead to you wanting to complicate things a little bit more in your hockey pools. Justin of Belgoni says, my wife picked me up at the bar. Who would have thought? God. That always makes you feel good too, right?
Oh, that's...
I guess kind of technically, Tammy kind of picked me up.
The courter or the courted?
Yeah. Yeah, now that I think about it. Yeah.
You did
She came up to me.
She rescued you.
Oh, man. Well, that's good to know.
Oh, there's a Cook County story in here?
I met my wife at Cook County.
There you go.
She stared me down from across the dance floor. Well, that's creepy. Sounds like a stage 5 clinger. But you ended up marrying her, so that's great. Oh, I like this one. This is good. This is going to tie in nicely to Macramalla. Guys, do I bet my life savings on Michael Porter's unders tonight? He's listed as questionable with an illness. Oh, I don't know. All right. We got to get into that. We've got Eric Macramalla popping by for Park Mazda, obviously. To get to some Macramalla intros that have been flying in so far today. Sorry if I missed them. We've had a bunch. EST legal analyst and guy who doesn't have any imaginary friends, but has 3 imaginary acquaintances. Eric Macramalla. EST legal analyst and guy who's not only named most of his skin tags, but also has them engaged in mock battles when he's in the bathtub. Man. That's absolutely gross. EST legal analyst and guy who likes to assert his dominance over his dentist by eating 3 cloves of garlic, 2 onions, and 2 score bars in the waiting room before his appointments.
Score bars.
Who's the boss now? Mr. Bob Ridley Jr., who's my dentist and is a good guy. EST legal analyst and guy whose hobby is writing Oscar-worthy scripts for remakes of random amateur adult films. EST legal analyst and guy who's one man off-Broadway reimagining of the film Tombstone has been reviewed as exciting, action-packed, and mostly just a naked man in assless chaps shooting finger guns for 2 hours and 30 minutes.
With the red sash.
That's it. He's got the red sash. All right. They're good. They're good. 780-218-9999. All right, let's bring him in. There he is. A busy man this week. A busy man this week, Eric Macramalla.
Let me flip. It's flipped. No, it's still not flipped. That off-Broadway play did well, but not as well as my other off-Broadway play, Vagina Monologues. Let me tell you something. That one really hit home with a lot of people. And yada, 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 court order. But before the court order, let me tell you, I really connected with my many, many fans.
You thought you were moving the needle, didn't you?
Thought I was moving something.
Yeah, Eric Macramalla with us on the show this morning. It's been an interesting week.
It was just weird because the entire time, I had a sidekick. It was weird. It was a Jeb Bush. But his energy was so low the entire time. I was like, you have to go. I still blame Jeb and his low energy for yada, 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 the court order.
Eric Macramalla with us on the show this morning. Brought to you by the great staff at Park Mazda.
Trademark lawyer for Slipknot.
Trademark lawyer for Slipknot. Right? Slipknot? Is this the truth?
Yeah, we talked about it. Yeah, Slipknot.
Was I not here that day?
No, I don't remember. I think we brought it up
a long time ago, maybe.
I just wanted to confirm with you.
No, it wasn't that long, actually. No, it was maybe 6 to 8 months ago on your new smash hit, Maverick-esque radio station. Who else? Michael Jackson's estate, Whitney Houston's estate, The Fray.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, all their songs. Who else? Tell me who else. Lizzo, Halsey, other people like that.
He's a busy guy.
I'm not busy. I have nothing to do. Nothing.
That's the best part of a lawyer's life. You dress nice, you sit around. It's great. You did get a haircut. It looks nice.
You like my haircut? Are you ready for this? Are you?
It's tight.
I'm going to say this, and this is going to blow your mind because you look at me, you're like, oh. Like, this is model, Eric, right? This is like model. I'm going to be 50 years old on Friday. 50.
Your birthday's on Friday?
Man. Wow. Yeah, good Friday or awesome Friday, as I call it.
Man, you look great for 50. I put you at like 44, 45 max.
maybe 42 and a half, but I have no lower body. That's the crazy part. I'm just a stump.
Eric Macramalla with us.
Perfect radio.
All right, we have to get to betting in sports. You got something going on in the NBA with Jontay Porter on the Raptors, and then obviously you've got this Shohei Ohtani situation. I know you were tweeting about it yesterday. Your thoughts on how this situation has been handled and how carefully Ohtani worded some of his things when he had his availability.
I laughed because, yeah, I tweeted, but I also tweeted out an article that I wrote for Forbes saying Ohtani said what he had needed to say.
Yeah.
But every time I post, I think about you because you complain about Forbes, I guess, because for your when you use it, there's lots of ads and stuff, I guess, right? That's the problem. So I'm sorry. I don't see them, right? Because I'm the one who drafts.
You're
them,
behind
so
the scenes, yeah.
But I think about you all the time. I think about you all the time generally. Ohtani, Shohei Ohtani. So he did that press conference with his new interpreter. By the way, I'm pleased to report I watched the press conference very carefully. His interpreter was not stealing from him during the press conference. Which was really, really great. Yeah, I tried to see his left hand slide over and just grab his wallet. That would have been awesome. Plus, he looked like he was, I don't know, Hispanic, which that was amazing as he spoke Japanese. I'm like, this is the greatest day of my life. But so here's the thing. Remember last Tuesday, his interpreter, Ipe Musahara, said, oh, Shohei knew about this, and he wired $4.5 million to cover my gambling debts. The next day, Ohtani's legal team said, no, it's not true. It's massive theft, bigly, tremendous theft. The reason they said that is for the following. In the state of California, sports betting is still illegal. It's legal in 40 states, but in 10, including California, it's legal. So if you place bets with a bookie in California, if you place them, you could be charged criminally. On top of that, if you simply wire money to a bookie in California, you can be found to be engaged in a conspiracy associated with unlawful gambling. So you could be charged criminally. So that's why, one of the reasons why, maybe it's the truth as well, but who knows? I mean, why they've disavowed any connection whatsoever to Ipe Musahara and his gambling, right? And it's a lot because $4.5 million in debt, you're looking at $80 million probably gambled over 10 years. That's just my math, but that's insanity, right? So that's the reason. Now, is it true? That's the big thing, right? I don't know. I mean, in the press conference, they never addressed how Ipe Musahara had access to Ohtani's bank account, number one. Number two, when you send substantial funds via a wire, it gets flagged. There are terrorism laws in the U.S. and there are bank laws. And so it gets flagged. So the account holder, namely Ohtani, would have been aware this is being sent. So none of that was addressed. The other thing is his interpreter, Ipe Musahara, said, oh, yeah, no, you're right. He didn't know about any of this. But here's the thing. Ohtani, in his press conference, what does he become? Witness number one, right? So now once you become a witness against Ipe Musahara, then things can turn. Who knows what he's going to say? And this will turn on the evidence, maybe some forensic evidence. Did he have access to the account? Did he forge his signature? It's tough. But maybe it was a Japanese bank account, but I doubt that the Dodgers would drop money in an American bank account. So if it's Japanese, then you don't have the same safeguards. So the bottom line is, if Ohtani wired funds to this California bookie, and did so knowing it was to cover gambling debts, then he could be charged criminally. Now, the other thing is, in his press conference at the end, and I isolated that on my show offside that no one listens to, at the end he said, I want to conclude that I never willfully wired money. It's like he hadn't said that before for the whole press conference. That's important because if he wired money to the bookie but not knowing what it was for, then he's in the clear. But then, of course, why would he wire?
Who's going to send $4.5 million to a bookie and be like, I wonder what he's using it for? I wonder why I have to send this. Like, this all comes down to if they can prove that the interpreter had full access to Ohtani's account, right? Is that not
exactly
right?
Like that's the thing, and that's why people I think are a bit confused. Is, well, if Ohtani didn't bet, he doesn't strike me as someone that would bet. I don't know him, but it's just my sense. And but he's still. And then there's the other issue, the IRS, right? When you wire those kinds of funds, you got to declare that kind of stuff. So you know, open to claims, criminal claims for bank fraud, wire fraud, tax evasion. So
it's just so hard to believe that Ohtani knew nothing about it. You know, that's just.
Yeah. Well, remember what I just said.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Willfully.
I said, like, if you have nearly $5 million in gambling debts, that would suggest, the math would suggest about $80 million gambled over 10 years. So how do you not know? But I mean, again, the interpreter, Ipe Musahara, has a history of lying, right? He said he worked for the Angels or for the Dodgers. No, for the Yankees. It was just lies about being interpreter. So, but again, it's access. How do you get access, right? So, look, you know what? Here's the thing is that Ohtani might have said, look, I'll cover your debt because I love your last name, Musahara, but don't do it again. So he might have thought he was doing his buddy a solid.
Like he's clearing really him. He's friend. Like, this is enough. But I'm helping you out of a jam.
That doesn't absolve you of criminal liability because you didn't know it was against the law. Now, fair enough here. I didn't know it was against the law in California. I was watching Seinfeld that pulled up the California Penal Code, which is a criminal code. In the U.S., criminal laws is governed state by state, whereas in Canada, it's federal. It's one criminal code for the whole country. And it took me forever, but I found it. Section 337 sub A, sub 3. It's like, oh, okay. Yeah, you can't wire funds. You know, that's also a problem. So how would he know, right? How would he know?
How do you think this landscape changes? Like, we see what's happening with Porter and some of these under bets that have cashed on nights when he left games and they were the highest bet, highest winning, highest cashed out totals that night in the NBA on various sports books. How do you manage this landscape moving forward when the leagues are like, give me all the money, give me all the betting money, give me all the betting money? And then you see these issues continue to pop up where if a football player is betting on this sport, he can get in trouble. Or if he's betting on college football like Jameson Williams, but he's doing it from the Lions facility. Like, this is just a tough can of worms to manage, is it not?
It is a bit of a mess. I was really impressed with myself on my show yesterday when I said that gambling has become integrated into our sports experience.
Yes.
I thought that was a really good sentence. And I was really proud of myself.
But when you use a word like integrated, it's great. I would just say it has become a part of, right? So it's great.
Yeah, it's integrated. I mean, I could use the word synergy. I'm not quite sure how to use it in the sentence. People like to use synergy, then shake your hand and squeeze your elbow. So I would say two things. First, there's people who say, well, the owners are hypocrites, right? There are these billionaires that make money off gambling, but then punish players for gambling. Well, it's not a... They're not hypocrites. It's not a contradiction. It's a paradox, a seeming contradiction at best, because the players profit off that. In hockey, it's hockey-related revenue includes gambling. So the players in the sports make money off of it, number one. Number two, it's a mess because gambling and sports, because it's integrated into our sports experience, has become normalized. And there's also ease of access with respect to gambling apps, right? So there's a real existential threat for sports. Here's the thing is the threat is not your superstars. It's not Connor McDavid or Patrick Mahomes or, you know, Travis Kelce. It's the bit players. It's this Porter guy, you know, the guy off the bench. It's the fourth line winger, guys who know that the earning potential is profoundly finite and their careers are profoundly finite. It's a running back who knows his career won't last more than 3 to 4 years. They have insider information. They have an ability to place bets and have control over that and make some money. They can supplement their revenue stream by doing that. That's the threat, guys. The threat is from the bit players, not from the stars. But it's a threat. Let's not forget, why do we have a commissioner in sports to begin with? Because of the Black Sox scandal, 1919, right? The White Sox threw the World Series to, ironically, the Cincinnati Reds. So ironically, because Pete Rose later on managed to life play for the Reds, you know, because of gambling. And public confidence was so shaken in baseball, the owners got together in 1919 or 1920 and said, we have to appoint a commissioner, sort of an impartial steward of the game. So they tapped this guy he's a retired federal court judge, Kennesaw Mountain Landis, and said, can you be our commissioner, an impartial person to oversee the game as a fiduciary, basically? He said, yes. That's why we have a commissioner. It's because of gambling. So 100 years later, feels like we're kind of back where we started. Oh, I like how I ended that sentence.
The full circle.
Musahara.
Full circle.
Musahara.
Eric,
it's fun to say, isn't it?
I had one more for you, and it's going off the betting train. I'm staring down
Musahara is a low-energy loser. Yes, go ahead.
Another Forbes article, from your peer, Brian Bouchard. I don't know if that's maybe Bouchard. It's Brian Musahara.
He's good friends with Musahara.
That's exactly it. NFL owners approve major kickoff rule changes. Head injury fears linger. Your thoughts on the rule changes, specifically the kickoff, and how much are they pushing the CTE train down the track here with this?
I think there was a change coming to kickoff. After he moved it up the touchback to the 25-yard line, there was talk of two scenarios. Either eliminate the kickoff altogether. The reason is because players a disproportionately high number of players get hurt on a kickoff because the players are running down the field like these sort of these battling rams, right?
Yeah.
And the collisions are massive. So players were suffering concussions and having serious injuries as a result of that. So it was either get rid of the kickoff or push the players closer together. Those who don't know what it's going to look like is the defensive, the kick return team and the defensive side, on the defensive side, they're going to be really close to each other, right? So you can't generate a lot of speed before you hit someone. So this is the reason it's being done, is you address health and safety, very much like the hip drop tackle that's been banned, right? Where that you grab a guy from behind or the side and then you make your body dead weight and pull him down. We saw Mark Andrews, tight end for the Ravens. That's how he broke his leg, right? I forget the name of the guy who did it. It was really cheap. He did it to two players this season, right? What was his name?
I can't remember. Player. I can't remember.
Who was he? He was playing for the Lions, right? He was the Lions. Anyway, he did it twice this year. He broke two legs. Animal. I like how you close your eyes.
Well, I was trying to remember the name because I am a Lions fan, but
you are.
I should know this off the top of my head, but I don't. I'm disappointed.
Well, type in Lions defense. I'm cheap shot artist.
Logan Wilson.
Is that who it was? I don't think so. Oh, well, it doesn't matter when it's all said and done. But they're trying to create with the safety, and we'll see where the rest of the leagues go as well.
Yeah, I'm just checking it now, but I just typed in Lions Mark Andrews, but nothing came up. But, yeah, it's a shame. Are we on the air now?
It says here Andrews suffered.
Oh, Logan Wilson.
Logan Wilson of the Bengals. Okay. Okay, that's why I couldn't think it was
Lions. Yeah, okay, so I got it wrong. So it was the other Lions guy, though, who did it to someone else. And so, I mean, that's what they want to do. And, you know, the thing is that oftentimes we don't want to see changes in something because we've done something a certain way for a long time. And that by itself becomes an obstacle or opposition to change. But you need to embrace change. It's fluid. I mean, look at you guys. Change is inevitable. And if you're not agile and you're not nimble, you are going to die. So there's nothing wrong with this. We'll see how it sorts out. But the owners passed it unanimously, despite the players not being in favor of it. Why? Because they want to protect their employees and they want to protect their revenue streams. Mark Andrews going down was a big deal for the Ravens. Agreed?
Big time. Big time. And fantasy teams everywhere, which needs to...
Bigger deal.
To think about that. Macramalla, great time today, buddy. We appreciate it. We'll catch up next week.
I love you. By then, I'll be 50. I'm really
Yes,
scared.
That's right. Happy birthday on Friday, man.
Happy birthday.
Enjoy it.
Okay, I'm going to come see you on my birthday. I'm taking the kids this weekend down to Houston for my birthday. We're going to catch a couple of Yankees-Astros games. That'll be fun.
Well, that'll be a lot of fun. Happy birthday, buddy. We'll talk next week, you old bastard. Yeah. See you later.
I love you guys more than Jeb Bush.
There you go. That's Eric Macramalla, our legal analyst, brought to you by Park Maz. A lot of good insight on the Ohtani thing and how this is going to sort itself out. Fascinated to see how that conversation continues to grow. All right, we got to get moving along there. It was kind of nice because we can go a little bit longer now because of the new format.
When you have a legal mind
that
deals with Slipknot and Lizzo and the rest, you got to get the most juice out of that.
Yeah, get the most juice out of that one. 780-218-9999. If you'd like to play Kind of Easy Trivia right now, 780-218-9999. We've got a gift certificate locked and loaded just sitting here waiting for you for Mr. Mike's Steakhouse Casual, the casualest place ever. All you need to do is get 3 of the 5 questions correct. Marshall's been on spring break. He's been crushing these. He's just been crushing them. He's like, Daddy, I got to play. I was like, wow, just keep playing, practicing.
Setting records,
just
practicing. Cracking knuckles.
Yep. Let's see here. Yeah, you're going to get this. If you want to play Kind of Easy Trivia, 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. Text YouTube Travel, let them know you want to play. 3 questions too many coming up here. More goal songs on the way as well. 8:20 today. That's good for Italian Center Shop. Greg Wyshynski via video at 8:30 today. And at 8:45 today, we will attempt to play the A&W song a cappella. We'll have the tuba.
We will.
You're on the block.
We will play the song.
I got the triangle, and we're going to do that around 8:45 today. Could be awesome. Could be an absolute disaster, which would also be awesome. So we'll see how that happens. But if you want to play Kind of Easy Trivia, 780-218-9999. If you're looking for work, we've got a place that's looking for you. Eric's got more on that here during the update.
Edmonton Oilers back in the win column last night with a 4-3 overtime victory over the Jets down in Winnipeg. Zach Hyman scoring the winner, his 51st of a hard-working campaign. Leon Draisaitl Ryan Nugent-Hopkins and Connor Brown also getting the goals. The Oilers are back home to host the Kings tomorrow night. Other action last night, so Nashville's point streak extended to 18 games. They scored three straight in the third, defeating Vegas in overtime 5-4. Colorado's nine-game win streak snapped as they fall at home to the Habs 2-1. Capitals 4-3 over Detroit, and the Stars doubling up the Sharks 6-3. A quiet night in the NHL with just a pair of games this evening. Tampa Bay hosts Boston, while Buffalo are at home to Ottawa. Over to the NBA, Austin Reaves had a triple-double. Lakers winning in double overtime, 128-124 over Milwaukee. 12 games around the NBA tonight, including the Raptors looking to shake an 11-game slide when they host the New York Knicks. Sports update for Claiborne Services. Take your career to the next level with Claiborne Services. They are hiring all positions, including journeyman bricklayers and apprentices of all levels. Take advantage of their outstanding mentorship program and work with peace of mind knowing they are an industry leader in safety. Visit www.claiborneservices.com or make it easy and give Jeff a call, 780-910-6728.
Mustache, 'cause he's too young, but he's playing like a superstar. Oilers took him at number 93 on, and he's been great so far. No one was sure if he would make the team. Scott said his vision was the very best. Game-winning goals in 5-point nights. It sure looks like he passed the test. He's like 99 in a way. He rarely makes a mistake. He's on the right track, baby. Or the Nuge can play. Just make your way to the net. Stick on the ice and you're set. The Nuge will find you, baby. He was born to play.
Dry? Not. Dry, not.
Oh, the Nuge can play. Finding the back of the net on a ridiculous feed from one Connor McDavid. Puts it in the back of the goal, and the Edmonton Oilers end up almost blowing it against Winnipeg, but then recovering, getting the extra point in overtime.
Adam, right where they want him, eh? That's...
Yeah, I don't want to be the guys
it's
who like
a cat with a bowl of yarn.
Yeah, I don't want to like gloss over the fact that they did have a 3-1 lead with 13 minutes left and let it slip away.
But
they did get the win in the end.
A win is a win is a win. Man of the Preds, I was talking about that Thursday slate with all the games, and you were doing the Vince McMahon. The Preds visit Arizona, so like. Given the rate that they've been going on, that's another 2 points for them. It makes
if you're the Winnipeg Jets, you got to be a little bit worried.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, Trev, what's going on? How come you're shaking your head? He got hung up on. But did you talk to him and then he hung up on you? Ouch. That sucks. Hey, do you want to play Kind of Easy Trivia? Who is this? No, you're a loser. Click. What? What is this?
Don't be punking YTT.
On our first Wednesday? That's a tough look. Having some fun today with... Evan, on a Wednesday, and we found some pretty good clips. You got to send in your text messages for this. I think this is how you probably get in on text of the day today.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
We've had a lot of good ones on this. Connor Brown.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
The Nashville Predators.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Shohei Ohtani to his interpreter.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Austin Reaves.
There's the Austin Reaves last night.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
All right, so send us your who the hell are you all of a sudden text messages to 780-218-9999. You could get in the mix for the text of the day for A&W. Two juicy mamas and a big moment for A&W coming up. I don't want to say it's one of the biggest moments in A&W history, but it's probably right up there.
Well, it's a good chance for them to kind of not a soft rebrand, if you will. A remix on the original, right?
Dr. J's coming in.
Yeah.
He's got the tuba. We're going to be playing the block and the triangle, and we'll see how this goes. 218 likes. Now, somebody was like, too many songs, and everybody else is like, more songs, more songs, more songs. Look, we're already at 218 likes, If we can hit 250 likes by 8:30, I'll run back that Yes, a Puljujarvi song in the second half of the third hour, too. He gets his third of the year yeah. for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
And people are still requesting that. Here's one from the burglar. Wheels running into Dusty and Lieutenant Eric after cleaning his glasses for the first time ever.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Real good. Real
That's
good.
A good one. I like that one. That's good. all right, keep those coming in. This could be a real nice day on the text line. Real nice day. All right, let's get into three questions too many. We got to keep the show. We need one more question for three questions too many. If you have one, fire it in. 780-218-9999. It can be whatever you want. What other questions? Do you want to ask a question, Trip? Is that
kind of easy trivia.
Oh, we've not done trivia. Oh, yeah, trivia. Yeah.
Is that okay?
Man, I
got him back. I got him back.
Okay, who do we have?
Same guy?
Casino Dealer J.
Casino Dealer J. Trev, thanks for keeping us on track, man. I'm just really excited for That's Good because we got those donuts kicking around. That's real nice. Kind of easy trivia for Mr. Mike's Steakhouse Casual. The casualest place ever. Find them in the Hampton Inn on the corner of 137th Ave, Mark Messier Trail. Or as I like to say, find the Hampton Inn in Mr. Mike's.
Oh,
6 o'clock your lager on tap. Casino Dealer J. Let's go to him. You ready to play, man?
Dusty, my favorite guy. That's the child represent.
My favorite guy, Usain Bolt. Sure, That's good. I like that. All right, here we go, man. You need 3 of 5. I'll start the ticker after read the first question. Good luck. Who scored the overtime winner for the Oilers last night?
Oh, let's see. That was Hyman.
True or false? Zach Hyman now has 200 career goals.
True.
Which goalie took the loss for the Jets?
Hellebuck.
Which Leaf currently leads the league in goals?
I don't want to answer that.
Which Oiler led the league in goals last year?
Oh,
you got it. He got it.
You can't have a newcomer come in and steal a show.
That's a peddling.
Oh, we've been strong. We're just playing by the rules.
Ooh, you better believe that's a peddling.
And I was in Miami with my new beach house. Well, it was a couple minutes from the beach.
That's a peddling.
The first year, we took it to the limit.
Take it to the limit.
You cannot come to my house. No, 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 not today.
You cannot come to my house. No, 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 not today.
Casino Dealer Jay.
Just like the Oilers there, 3-1 up. Never
Slow
in doubt.
Start.
Never in doubt.
Slow start. Yeah, we knew he was going to get it.
He was playing around.
He was messing around.
I like how the first one he hums and haws. It's like, yep. Yep.
Yeah, they got rolling after that.
I don't want to answer that.
Owen loves his mama.
That's a good one. I like that too. Keep those texts rolling in. That Atif one was, that was pretty good. Keep these flying in.
Another one here. The composer of the original A&W theme song to you guys this morning.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
That's a good one, too. Is that a text?
That's from Dudley this morning as
Dudley.
Well.
Yeah. Dudley. All right. That's a good one, too. I write these down. That's keep them coming in. Who the hell are you all of a sudden? Dave Jameson when he walks in here on the hangout today.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Yeah. That'll be a lot of fun, too. All right. Now we can get to three questions too many. Congratulations to Casino Dealer Jay. Eric, do you have a liner for three questions too many today?
Three questions too many brought to you by the great staff at Park Mazda, where dealer principal Mitch Lewicki instructs his entire staff to greet people at the door with...
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Park Mazda, your dealer for life.
Do you have a Twitter account?
@Lieutenant_Eric. You can follow on Twitter. I put out a poll this morning.
You did?
Yeah. It's, play ball tomorrow as yes. You'll be breaking out the windbreaker.
Let's play ball. It's game day.
We could...
We want strikeouts, base hits, double plays.
Simply put, will the Toronto Blue Jays make the playoffs? Mm. Your options are yes and no.
Okay.
Yes right now, 32.9%, with the no coming up at 67.1%. And this is off a TSN.ca piece. Orioles pick to dominate AL East. Jays outside playoffs in MLB predictions.
That doesn't surprise me. I took them under 86.5.
Yeah.
But I'm a little bitter after the offseason. What offseason?
What offseason? It's a wild card squeaker. Hey, if anything, right? Like, it should be interesting, right?
Yeah.
I mean, winning the division midsummer, that's a boring season. You want to be playing right down to the wire.
You want to be the Nashville Predators. Red hot down the stretch.
It'll be exciting.
All right, give him a follow, Lieutenant underscore Eric. Question number one. Can you imagine this question coming into the inbox 3 weeks ago? I can't. Boys, would you give Connor Brown a bump up the lineup with the way he's been scoring?
You're smiling, so it's like we're kind of...
I'm gonna say no right now.
If he keeps it up.
And the answer's likely no here. However, I will say they're still looking for some scoring on the right side. And
well, if he can provide it, great.
Look, you started him on the top line coming off of an injury. Now he's up to speed and actually playing a little bit. If you thought... Now, you're not going to separate Hyman and McDavid, so I guess it's a non-starter.
Wouldn't that be something, hey?
But yeah, wouldn't that be something? Hyman's got 51, Brown's got 3, and...
what do you say now, Berkshire?
No, I don't think so.
No, but okay, the spirit of the question, though, is, I mean, you'd like to see him continue, and if he even works himself into some sort of question, not the top line, but even...
I'll give you like a hot take for tomorrow, but I'll throw this one out there. He was more noticeable than Ryan McLeod yesterday.
Okay. There,
McLeod had that one chance. He got the puck and went to, he could have drove the net, but he stopped instead and tried to make a pass like 7 feet away from the net. Gager texts me. He goes, what the hell was that? So no, not yet, but I'm not going to like mock you for sending in the question, I guess.
No.
You never know.
No, I don't, but that's, yeah. And if, as an Oilers fan, I mean, yeah. Hope for the best and dream for the best. I mean, that's like, and they were talking yesterday during the break. I mean, that Jets team with the depth and Gabe Vilardi coming back from injury. I mean, that's what you want. You want guys to if you're not showing up, there's a guy that's showing up behind you. And we're not at that point yet, but dare to dream with Connor Brown.
They brought him in to be a top six / top nine guy.
Sure. If you get it's there by the end of the season,
for him to
who
get
cares?
Going, but it,
the middle
yeah.
part, whatever. Yeah.
It's part of the story, right? The journey here, the ups and downs, part of the end story. Ken Holland can sit here and go, I didn't say he'd be top six at the beginning of the year. Still highly unlikely, but I can see why you would ask with the production lately. Trev, no chance, though.
I don't know. I wouldn't be surprised if he got a look.
At some point down the stretch here?
Yeah, like I think he's playing a lot better now. So why not give him the look?
He's definitely playing better.
He is. Like, he's skating way better. The Toronto game, there wasn't a lot to look at, but, like, I was watching Connor Brown. I thought his skating in the last few games, last few weeks, is just, it's tremendously better. So, you know, he is playing better. So, I wouldn't say they're going to do it, but it sparks conversation, right? I think that's definitely something they'll be like, hey, you know, Connor Brown, like should we give him a look? He's looked a lot better. So I think I wouldn't be surprised if they did it, honestly.
What say you? Chime in 780-218-9999. Hit us up in the nasty chat. Once again, a question to the inbox this morning. Here's another one for three questions too many. With the Jays season just around the corner, where are we at on home run songs on the new show?
Great question. I guess we need to get going on that, hey?
Well, Maddie and I have been kind of dabbling around like what we can and what we can't play on YouTube. And our theory so far is play it, and then if it gets called out on a copyright, you just clip it out of the show.
This has happened before. They'll give you, a yellow card or a warning.
Yeah,
you say, sorry, we'll go in and...
So, I don't know. I feel like we might mix in a few of the home run songs.
Most of the home run songs aren't... like they're
Bobo Bichette.
Well, they're like Snowman. There's a lot of
different pieces
things,
and stuff.
Yeah,
right?
So it's not like a full.
Like the Alejandro Kirk might get claimed by like 7 different things.
Yeah, but are all those 7 going to claim like a half a second or a second here? So maybe it's a maybe we get around it some way somehow. Maybe we just need to get more inventive and you know sneaky with our home run songs in the future. I mean, there's got to be somebody a player this year that will. We'll focus on, but
question number
is there any Jay right now that you would say like
add a home run song for? No,
early days, I know, but
you know, we have Springer, we have Kirk, we have Bobo Bichette, we have Laddie. You know, we'll see what ends up happening with some of the new guys like Turner and stuff like that.
Yeah,
but we got the wheelhouse that we need right now, like the Springer song. Let's go. Question number 3, guys, do you think there's more coming with Adam Henrique? I'm not sure. This might just be what... Like, he's slower than I thought he was going to be. But he's effective in some parts of the game.
He's old.
I definitely don't think.
I say that in a good way.
I'm not sure the re-signing thing is going to happen.
That was talked about. And, yeah, maybe not. Look, yeah, he wasn't brought in to I mean, he was brought in as a depth piece to kind of elevate others and much like the first question, like how was this phrased again? Do you expect more? Definitively? Like, do we expect more from Adam Henrique? I don't. What more can we expect? He's there to provide some veteran.
Maybe my expectations for him were a little too high, I guess.
When that's one of the main pieces in a trade deadline acquisition in a cup window, I maybe don't fault you for having high expectations, but he is who he is.
Like, I don't think the Oilers can sit there right now and be like, this was a excellent. Now, the first is a first, but 75% was retained on the way in and stuff. So value-wise, yeah. I'm still okay with the value. I wonder if there's another. I wonder if there's another gear to Henrique's game. I think that's a fair question right now, and there might be. And
I
we'll
say
see. Come
yes,
playoff
and
time.
I expect him to hit it.
There you go. Okay, perfect. I so love it. You're always a. You're always there.
I demand more.
All right. Hey, let's do this.
Okay.
Let's do this. But with baseball just around the corner, I'm putting in the call to the pen for the lefty. We're gonna bring in the lefty. Piers is in and says, Lieutenant Eric, hour one of the podcast is only 27 minutes long. You're missing the second half of hour one. That's a YouTube Trev thing. You've been working on that. Trev, did you just not upload properly?
I'm looking
or what?
At it now. It should be good.
Might have to re-upload and see if that kicks in. No. We're talking about, what, your ears tickling or whatever this is?
Lieutenant Eric, because I'm grabbing the...
No. Somebody was reading a text about a podcast, but that's YouTube Trev's category right now. All right, look at this. That's a good...
Look at that.
For the Italian center shop, they dropped off more donuts. Four of them, they didn't drop them off. Maddie went and picked them up yesterday. Let's get into these bad boys.
And we don't know what's
inside.
No,
they haven't. It looks like Maddie didn't even get in. I thought Maddie would have had one yesterday.
What a guy.
I can't get into
what
this.
What a guy.
Oh, yeah, get in here.
Well, don't tip it over.
I think they'll still be good.
You got pizza box you're carrying under your arm.
Oh, baby. Look at this. Look at that. That's good. How are you not picking these up for somebody at work today? Like, come on. Trev's mouth is like open. He's like,
He's moaning.
Trev, you know what I'll do? First overall pick.
I love it.
Come here, buddy.
Pressure's on
are
now.
You serious?
I'm serious. First overall pick in today's donut draft. That's good. Don't take the one I want or I'll kill you. All right, there you go, buddy. What do you think this is? This is cool. That looks like a pink sort of coconut thing. Got a lovely set of pink coconuts.
Son of a chocolate dip, eh? Are you serious?
That was going to be my first overall pick. He took the chocolate dip.
Out of all the interesting assortments here, you're going chocolate dip.
I cannot believe you sniped me like that.
You going to get a filled one here or a hollow?
Can I choose second?
Absolutely.
Well, I'm just going for the regular glaze. I love these things. Look at this. It's delicious. Oh, my God. But come on, man. These donuts are bloody delicious.
Well, if you're going to get donuts, which is a good play, I mean, glue guy Jay Milne usually brings some baked goods in and everything. And
real nice.
I'm not complaining there. But if you really want to get donuts for the crew at work, friends, whatever, bringing some treats home for family, you don't. Don't go halfway. Like don't go get donuts that are stale with the toppings falling off and everything else. Homemade, a variety of flavors, I mean, just the box looked nice.
What are you going with?
Looks like a bouquet. I'm still thinking don't know because
well,
it's a very.
I'm gonna say that's good. For Italian Center Shop, Connor Brown, third goal of the season. First two came in garbage time, just going to the net. This was a nice shot, kind of getting going a little bit. It's just good for him. Good for him to stick with it, and now it's starting. He's starting to, what do you say, reap the rewards.
He's reaping.
Reap the rewards of this. Also, that's good. Connor Brown kind of starting to move the needle a little bit after a lot of patience to get to the spot. You know, Macramalla today when he was on, he said battling rams, and I always thought it was a battering ram. I thought that was a saying, like a couple of battering rams.
He's also mispronouncing the gentleman's name.
Yeah, that's true, the whole time. All right, what are you going with, buddy?
I don't know. What do I do? I'm trying to look
swing,
at what's
swing by an Italian center shop today, pick up a dozen donuts for the crew. They're going to think you're a hero. It's just that simple. Let me give you the read on these donuts.
I wish I had a legend.
Because it's very simple, but it's also delicious. House-made dough, fried to perfection. then finished with delicious glazes, rich custard, and all your favorite toppings, made fresh every single day in-house. Mm. What you got? You got custard in there?
See, what I'm talking about here, you bite it, beautiful, and the toppings stay on. And the custard's right
there.
Yeah,
nothing falls off.
First bite. I'm not taking 20 bites down to the end, and it's a custard bomb, and there's custard all over the place. First bite, custard. First bite, little toppings, and it's all still on.
You know who's going to love these?
Lovely.
Evan Dobb and Dave Jameson. They're in on the hangout today with Matt Awanek, 9 o'clock. Gotcha. They want Italian Center Shop donut? We got one for them. Trev, how's your donut going, buddy? Real nice?
It's so good, man.
Yeah, it's so good. He's in heaven. All right, let's get to a sports update with Lieutenant Eric. Oh, no, we don't need a sports update. We can just get into Greg Wyshynski right away. So that's I'm rattled by the donut. I'm not going to lie.
Sugar intake.
780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. Propane Pimp with this text in. Guys, I've been very skeptical about Brown due to his speed when handling the puck. But the past few games, especially last night, he's skating with pace and the shot is coming off the stick with more fluidity. Is it possible that Evander Kane has the most important assist on the Oilers this season? That was the one that he threw across that got Connor Brown off the schneid, right? Well, probably not. I mean, McDavid's going to have over 100 of them. Yep, so there's probably a McDavid one in there a little bit more important.
But you make the case.
Yeah.
I'm here for it.
Understand where you are at on this one. Okay, this is great. We said phone be damned. And we now have Greg Wyshynski via video, brought to you by Metal Supermarkets, your convenience stores for metal. Any metal cuts a size ready fast. Two Edmonton locations, West End and South Side, or online. You can go in and order whatever metal you need for any job that you're working on. They got you covered. www.metalsupermarkets.com. There he is, Greg Wyshynski. You are a real person. Nice to see you, buddy.
I love it.
Yeah, all these you thought I was AI. You know, it's funny. I had a listener reach out to me on Twitter and say, I got to tell you, the trolling that you do on Nielsen's show is amazing. The way you always hang up and leave him hanging in the conversation. I'm like, buddy, it ain't a bit. I'd tell you if it's a bit. And if it was a bit, I'd do a lot less yelling and screaming on Wednesday mornings than I normally do. But I'm hoping that we've figured out the technological aspect of this. Yeah. And obviously the people in Edmonton get to see my cherubic face now. That was good too.
It's funny because you would have been disconnected so you wouldn't hear the reaction to your phone, but people, like the sound that we were hearing from your phone, people would just kept saying, he's hanging up. He's hanging up. That's a hang up sound. He's hanging up on you guys. I was like, that's an all like for to sure. Do it three times 1 week. Come on.
Like, let's be honest. Like if I was going to hang up, if I was going to punk you guys, like I certainly wouldn't do it in the middle of my own answer. I love hearing myself talk, right? I would do it as you're asking, you know, some inane question about Connor Brown. Like, and then you come back to me and it's just silence. Like that'd be the bit. I don't know. Well, hopefully this is now a solution. Cause I've been doing the show. I mean, people knew the show probably. I mean, I've been doing the show for like a decade now.
Over a decade. I think I remember. Yeah, so, remember when you were on with my very first co-host Chaser, and you and Kyle Chase got into a yelling argument about Canada and U.S. hockey that people still text in about, like, to this day. So, yeah, you've probably been on for, like, 13, 14 years, buddy. Like,
that's,
it's crazy.
That's to be expected. Yeah, you were about 13 or 14 years old, I think.
Yeah. pretty much. That's the truth. All right. I mean, so, last night was a big night in the National Hockey League, man. Some big games, most of them living up to the hype, including Edmonton and Winnipeg. And Zach Hyman. On a day in which, obviously, Berkshire had some hot takes on him, delivers goal 51 in overtime, and the Oilers avoid a choke job in which they blew a two-goal lead in third period to the Winnipeg Jets. But they'll certainly take it, and Hyman, season for the ages, continues for this guy.
Let me cook on Berkshire. All right, so it's completely reasonable to mention that Zach Hyman had an untypical advantage as a young hockey player growing up, where his family, not only because his family was wealthy, but his father purchased teams and leagues on which he played. His father purchased the entire ISS scouting service in his son's draft year. Like, it is completely okay to mention that in the pantheon of rich kids playing hockey, there were some untypical advantages that Zach Hyman may have had growing up. It is completely unreasonable to extrapolate that Hyman's NHL career was a byproduct in any way of those advantages. Like, as much as the NHL is an old boys network, at the end of the day on the ice, it's meritocracy. He had to earn his time at Michigan. He had to earn his time to play with Matthews. He had to earn his time to play with McDavid and Draisaitl. Like, do you think Connor McDavid gives a damn that this guy's dad is rich?
No.
No, he just damn this guy puts the puck in the net.
Yeah.
But that being said, like, there's been really truly bizarre, like, we must protect Zach Hyman at all costs thing that's happened in hockey in the last, like, 24 to 48 hours. You know, the hockey news is saying he should win the Masterton for having the perseverance to stick around until he's 31 years old to get a chance to be, like, the Chris Kunitz to Connor McDavid. Like, it's okay to say that 39 of his 51 goals were assisted by either McDavid or Dreisaitl, that he is a product of those players. Just like it's completely okay to say that 37 of Sam Reinhart's 51 goals were the product of either Matthew Tkachuk, Alexander Barkov, or both.
Yeah.
Like, it's okay to say that. I mean, it doesn't make either of these guys Jonathan Chychrun necessarily, but, you know, it also kind of puts things within context of, yeah, you play with good players, you're going to produce. It doesn't diminish it, and it's okay to have that conversation about Hyman's season. What's not okay is saying that, you know, he's having the season because his dad was loaded.
Yeah, yeah, that was bizarre. Kind of came out of nowhere yesterday and caught everybody off guard. And then I thought it was, you know, Oilers fans were obviously having some fun with it last night when Hyman scores the winner the way that he did. I think it worked out well.
And let me tell you right now, as both a veteran of the internet and a veteran of trolling, like, We will not get away from the Zach Hyman's rich dad meme.
Well, that'll be around forever now, right? Like, yeah.
Forever, yeah. Yeah. When he's lifting the Stanley Cup, God willing, in June, it's going to be, you know, whoa, is the cup filled with dollar bills from his dad? You know, it's going to be that kind of thing now in perpetuity. Because I say this as a guy who once called the Colorado Avalanche bland, and then they won the cup, and I still get Avalanche fans, texting me and stuff saying, are we still bland?
Yeah. Well, so this morning is one of those nights you can go back to and be like, yeah, you lost to the Habs 2-1 at home last night. So you got that going for you. That's a tough look. What about Winnipeg on the other side? I mean, Nashville refuses to lose. Incredible comeback against Vegas. They're closing in on the Jets to the point that you would have never thought they would have been capable of. Dallas has kind of separated themselves a little bit from the Jets. It doesn't look like the division is going to be there for the taking for Winnipeg. They've lost four in a row, got the point last night when it looked like they might not. What are you expecting from the Jets here down the stretch?
I mean, they've been a team all year where you watch them one night and you're like, I don't get it. And then you watch them another night and you're like, oh, this team could probably win the cup with the way they defend. They've been in a bit of a rut lately. I haven't dug into the numbers too much to figure out what exactly has gone awry with them. But they still have all the pieces in place to really be a very tough out in the playoffs. Not only do they, you know, can they score, but they've defended extremely well. They've got Hellebuck, obviously, and then they added a little bit of goal scoring even at the deadline. So I'm not quite sure why the fade is happening now. I do think that they're going to be a ridiculously tough out in the first round, no matter who plays them. But Nashville's the one, you know, that they're doing the usual, like, no one's paying attention to us thing. I think we've all been paying attention. I mean, it's very hard to not pay attention to a team that goes on an historic heater after being unable to watch U2 at the Sphere. Like, I think we all know where it started and where it's gone since then. But they're such an interesting team because, you know, they've got a veteran core of guys that they smartly augmented with Ryan O'Reilly in the offseason in service of a collection of pretty good young players. And they've got that balance right now. It's kind of an interesting mix. And I think whoever plays them in the first round, I still think ultimately you'd like to play them more than you'd like to play the Kings or the Golden Knights, for example. But I mean, whoever plays Nashville in the first round is going to have a tough out.
Greg Wyshynski with us, ESPN. Greg, just staying in the West here, and a great slate tomorrow night with some tantalizing matchups, one of which being the Oilers and the Kings. Kings 7-3 in their last 10, but still just a point up on the Golden Knights, who, you know, again, last night we saw Predators coming from behind and the Golden Knights occupying that second wild card spot. Tell us a little bit more about the Kings, winners of four straight, 7-3 in their past 10, setting up a real heavyweight tilt tomorrow night down here in Edmonton.
I mean, you know about the Kings. Edmonton fans know intimately about the Kings. Now, they've obviously made some augmentations since last time you saw them in the playoffs with Dubois coming aboard. And the other big change, I think, obviously with the Kings this year, besides the coaching change and the change in goal, is the younger players, I think, uniformly have been better year over year, which makes them a more dangerous team than they were last year. But again, like, when you start to think about playoff seeding, and it's the only thing we can really think about now in the West, because I don't think there's really a race for anybody to hop into the wild card at this point. I think the Blues at last check have like a less than 5% chance of making the playoffs.
Six pack.
So like I think if you're Edmonton, you still want to play the Kings. I don't think you want to play Vegas, obviously, not only because of the playoff history there, but because the Kings are the Kings. That's all they're going to be. The Golden Knights are going to basically have a second trade deadline at the beginning of the playoffs when they get Mark Stone back, potentially, when they get other guys back from LTIR. Like, they're going to get such a rocket boost from their lineup being made whole again that combined with just how they play defensively makes them a team I don't think Edmonton wants to play. I think you take the Kings over the Knights 100 times in the first round if you're Edmonton.
What about in the East? Like, I was kind of on the Panthers wagon for quite some time, still probably am. But it's a great race at the top of the East as well. You would watch the East more than us. How do those top-end teams, like there's the four teams and then there's Toronto kind of lurking around. How do those teams sort themselves out, do you think?
I mean, Boston's the inexplicable one, to be honest with you. I think that they've obviously like been able to do what they've done this season on a really strong foundation of Jim Montgomery defensive system and the best goaltending tandem in hockey. And Pastrnak, I mean, for all the MVP talk, like he probably is a guy that should be higher on the rankings with the way that he's played for them this year, especially in the absence of any discernible number one center. The Rangers are a team I've seen a lot. I think there are nights where you squint hard enough and you think that they can win the cup, but I still think that when matched up against a real defensive pro in the playoffs, I think they're going to struggle. And I'm not enamored with them on the back end beyond Fox, to be honest with you. The team that I saw that blew me away recently was Carolina. Now, granted, they played the Islanders, which is, you know, there might be a little bit of a Harlem Globetrotters effect going on there, but they're just really good. And they've gotten so much better with Gensel in the lineup and with adding Kuznetsov. Because we've talked about this before, like the major malfunction for Carolina in the playoffs year after year after year with Brendan Moore behind the bench is the inability to score a key goal at a key time to turn a game or turn a series. Well, in Gensel, they have a point-per-game guy in the playoffs. In Kuznetsov, they have a guy who, you know, uniformly has been a playoff hero in the past. And you can see how that lineup has been different with them in it. And you can easily see how, in the playoffs, they could be the difference makers to finally get Carolina over the hump. So let's go. Let's party like it's 2006 again.
Yeah, man. Oilers, I would melt this city down, man. If they went up against Carolina and lost again, I mean, we would have 10 years of content. I mean, it would be absolutely insane. What do you got, Rick?
Well, the foot of the East, Greg, and the Devils with the win over the Leafs last night, sending this nation into peril here. Keefe ripping the Leafs for an immature performance against New Jersey. Is it too little too late for the Devils? I mean, games played right now kind of not in their favor. 3 points back at Detroit. Detroit, who are, and that three-point night last night with the Capitals and the Red Wings.
That's a killer.
Too little too late, Greg?
I'm just thinking, like, if you're calling your team immature and they're playing the Devils, that means your team basically played like a fetus. The Devils are not exactly, you know, the Boston Bruins over here as far as experience go. It's too little too late. I mean, the Devils have left too many points on the board, I think, in the last few weeks. A loss to Ottawa, for example, and some other games that they, you know, could have pushed to overtime to get a point and couldn't. They've dug their own hole and they deserve to be in it. I mean, no team in the league has given up the first goal in a game more than the Devils had. They had to, you know, climb out of another hole last night. You know, it's encouraging that they haven't quit. It's encouraging that they're playing meaningful games, and they still are a team that could go on a 9-game heater and finish out the season and make it really interesting based on, you know, the fact that they're getting decent goaltending now from Jake Allen. Kaapo Kakkonen got the first shutout for the Devils all season the other night against the Islanders. They were the last team in the league not to have a shutout. So they're playing a little bit better defensively. They're getting better goaltending, and obviously their offense can still really, really rock it. But, I mean, you know, the teams in front of them, even when they lose, they pick up points like the Flyers did last night. So that's the real struggle right now for Jersey.
Greg, what do you got coming up at ESPN this week?
For those who are interested, I got a good story on the site today about Boston College and Boston University. Like, best college hockey rivalry by far. I mean, it's on a level of like Michigan, Ohio State in college football. But I mean, those two teams were 1-2 in the country. They're on opposite sides of the NCAA bracket, so they could meet in the final for the first time since 1978. And you're talking Macklin Celebrini. You're talking Cutter Gauthier. You're talking Will Smith, Ryan Leonard. Like, there are a ton of really, really talented players on both of those teams. So I kind of dive into the rivalry and dive into some of the big name personalities that are involved in it.
Excellent. Thanks for not disconnecting the link partway through the conversation today. And we'll catch up next week.
I've been trying to kick out this wire in my router the entire time.
Exactly.
We're just going to have a fully formed conversation for once.
All right, man. We'll see you next week. There you go. That is Greg Wyshynski from ESPN. Brought to you by Metal Supermarkets, your convenience stores for... Metal! Greg Wyshynski. That was nice. It was good to... Yeah, Wyshynski's been coming on the show for 14 bloody years.
Well, somebody complimenting his hair in the nasty chat. Like, he's a good... He's a video. He's made for the... He's made for the screen, so it's good that we got him on here.
Yeah, no, it's... had a nice little setup there, too.
Yeah.
So that's good. With Trevin, that takes... You don't have to worry about the phone anymore. How excited are you for this?
Yeah, like, that was the worst.
That's the big story of the morning.
Yeah, so I felt terrible because every time I called him, I'm like, sorry, man. Like, but no, that was good. Good camera. It went through. It was smooth. Very smooth.
All right, I'll say this. I'm a little nervous right now. We're going to try this A&W song.
If you didn't
song.
Have the nerves, though, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, exactly. So you care. You care. You're passionate about it. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to play the A&W song as we set up the mic and move you over and get another chair in here for Dr. J as we dive in. So here's we're going to be playing this live coming up here right away. Done just in time. All right. I want to hear the beginning again, just so I know when we're supposed to start chiming in here. Trev, what do you got over there?
I believe it's called an egg pipe? Shaker egg.
All right.
Shaker egg. Let's go.
Okay. Let me bring your mic up, Rick. Let's see. You're good there?
Test.
All right. You're good there. And Dr. J, Jonathan, how you doing, man?
Pretty good.
Speak just a little bit closer. Pull that mic in a little bit more. There we go. Okay, so this was your idea to try this. What's your background? What's your background here?
I'm a band teacher at St. Francis Xavier, pretty close by, not a like a quick drive from here.
So okay.
Teaching band off and on for about 23 years.
So how many instruments can you play?
You can operate most of them, basically, like play a scale. This is what you learn in university.
Like pretty basic, like the,
one scale, yeah.
Yeah, so like I played trombone in grade 6 and 7. I was not good. We had 4 trombones. I was the third. The fourth trombone was a dude who didn't even care at all. So, but if I could play trombone, do you think I could play other instruments easily? Or is that just an easy one because you're just sliding?
You could get to this. You get to the, you mentioned the baritone. Trumpet could happen. French horn could happen.
Really?
That buzz. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I always wanted to play saxophone, but it looked way too confusing to me. Hey, that's
Alto. We were the alto boys. Yeah.
Was that the small one or the big one?
The smaller one. Yeah.
Is there
a smaller than the alto? It's alto baritone, right?
Soprano or? Is even smaller.
A soprano. Small. That's a little guy, maybe.
Kenny G.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Excellent. Okay. I want to just. I know you, Eric, and I are just going to listen one more time here. Just to Rick, let's listen and see when we're supposed to chime in on our part here. Let's see. So. Okay, so it's after. Okay. Whew, we're nervous. We were practicing here, Jonathan, and we'll see how it goes. Did you practice this morning, too?
Yeah.
Get your reps in.
All right, and Trev, you got the egg there that you're shaking, eh?
Yep, it's got a very nice sound to it.
All right, and, let's not go too loud on the egg.
Keep it back a little bit.
All right, so we just play off your cue here. This is, all right.
I'll run through it once. You guys come in the second time through. Let's do it 4 times through.
Okay, so you're going to run through it once. We come in the second time through. We'll go 4 times through. All right, here we go. I'm I think we did it. I think we did it. Was that mean, that was pretty good, I thought. I thought that went pretty good. I mean, we didn't.
No.
What do you think?
Pretty well, and you mentioned improvising yesterday. I think that's the right approach.
Yeah,
it's a bit of a jam.
Yeah. But I thought we got it. I thought it sounded pretty good.
It's great shaking.
Your reaction right now. Trev, what did you think? You were on the egg over there. How'd you feel about it?
I liked what. Yeah, I mean, it was unbelievable. This is insane. Look what we're doing right now.
Man, I actually feel like we actually did pretty good.
I think we're pioneers in terms of both music and art and sponsorship.
Yeah. I think A&W's got to be pretty happy with that.
I think so.
A couple of times when I hit this, it spun on me.
Yeah.
So I like missed on a beat, but I had to like react to it. There's a lot of pressure, man.
Live music's always exciting that way. Always.
Yeah. So do you like conduct the band and stuff too?
Yeah, we got a band class and a guitar class as well.
Really?
Yep.
That's good.
Maybe march in a parade here sometime soon. Hey, the four of us.
Yeah. Wouldn't that be something?
Stanley Cup. Yeah, somewhere near the back.
Somebody said we were just missing the drums. Hey, like, because the
we
were wondering if I could have like
if we had a spare kit.
I'm going to ask a music question here.
Sure.
It always sounds like the drums are always the same in most songs. Like, do people kind of get like a few different beats, and if you can do that, you can kind of play the drums or
pretty similar. You still have to read music. That's what I tell my percussionists. That's my background.
Yeah.
But also looking at this space, it's a pretty small space. That was we can't fit drums.
Yeah, we can't be in there. Like Trev can't be on a drum kit in the corner there, which would have been amazing. Yeah. Do you guys want to try it one more time? You want to do it one more time?
We're here.
Let's do it one more time. Right, everything might be better the second time. All right, here we go. We come in on this. We come in the second time around, Rick, right? Here we go. I love it. That was great. That was
hungry.
Awesome.
Hungry.
We are excited. Two juicy mamas for $9.99. Two juicy mamas for $9.99. We did it. Dr. J, thanks for coming in, man. Great idea. This is absolutely, that was a lot of fun. That was a lot of fun.
My way up.
Yeah. Pass these to the man. Yeah. Get these over there to Jonathan there. We'll get into the, hey, you should just stay sitting right next to me for the grand finale today.
It's a little weird here.
Yeah, imagine if we just did the show like this every day.
This is weird.
Third seat right over there, and Eric and I just sit beside each other
the whole
time.
I'll do the finale here. Yeah,
that'd be good. Stay in your boots and says, oh my God, that was so good. Standing ovation from Danny Boy.
Yeah. Well, if this doesn't garner a visit to A&W today for you, I don't know what does. Like, right? This is, in the spirit of the thing, head to A&W.
I feel like I missed my calling on the triangle. I think about it. There's probably, no, like, I mean, I should have been a triangle guy. Like, that's very cool. That's a real nice.
March down Jasper Ave. Hey, doing this?
Oh, we could definitely do that. Like, just three people. Why are these idiots walking down Jasper Ave right now? Like, we could definitely pull that.
Two mamas.
Pull that off. 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. Mikey's in and says, I think the wood blocky thing really held the piece together. Vance from Vandervan says, San Francisco Symphony Orchestra. Eat your hearts out. And Bergie says, taking a donut on the way out. Power move. Which was
the instruments.
Big Uke says, when I think of sports talk radio, this is exactly what I pictured. Thank you, gentlemen. Yeah, we got you rolling here. J. Siggy Rocker says, was that Trev's shaker or Dusty's laugh? Do I sound like the shaker right now?
I don't think so.
Trev, you did good on the shaker.
Yeah, I was a little nervous. I didn't get practice like that.
That's the thing. You weren't dreaming about it last night.
Yeah, I thought I was just going to orchestrate everything. Yeah. You know? And so that's what I was expecting. But I like to think that I did pretty good. This is a very difficult instrument. I kind of just got to shake my
hand. Yeah. But you know what? It flew under the radar, I think, and that's what you need from Egg Shaker Guy.
Yeah. I like it.
All right, let's get into the wrap for William Huff. If you want your place to look as good as ours, get it done at William Huff. Bruce and his super team of city superheroes wrapping the entire nation. You can find them at williamhuff.com. They've been doing it since 1972. They're really good at it, and they're great to work with. Once again, nice people and a good time. Eric, what'd you learn on the show today?
As we usually like to try to provide some entertainment and the information and education, as mentioned, Sheldon Keefe calling the Maple Leafs immature for their performance against the Devils, Dusty. This is huge. The Jays also outside the MLB prediction playoff picture this morning. So it's like it's trouble in TO today. But we also learned that it was a Wednesdays. And we learned that...
That was good.
Look, your wife, Tammy, and she's a very smart woman, but she had her doubts about Wednesdays.
She told me she thought it was stupid.
And that's fine. We're all entitled to our own opinion. She's not going to make a four-minute video and post it on Twitter about
Tammy,
it, though,
you nincompoop!
Well, you tell her you come home today, and you tell her, hey, you know what we learned on the show today? That it's great. And for one particular clip.
This is a different clip. This is me to my wife today.
Erin doesn't have a friend.
Yeah, you don't have any friends. But yeah, this clip hit today. This is what usually happens. It's like something really sort of stands out and we run with it.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Yes. Who the hell are you all of a sudden? We probably got time for a song here for a sound of the day, but that's a good one. And it's going to tie into
Who
text
the hell
of the
are
day,
you all of a sudden?
Which is coming up a little bit earlier or later on in the show. Evan Dom, Dave Jameson on the Hangout today. Another chance to qualify for the trip to Vegas.
When I sit next to you in the studio.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm sitting here. It's like.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
That's good. All right. What do we do for sound of the day? Connor Brown song? Hyman song? Nuge? Nuge hasn't scored in a long time. The Nuge can play. What do you think?
Keep going.
Drysdale song?
Keep going.
A&W song?
Keep going. We don't have a Lakers song. Keep going.
Oh, yes, Puljujärvi?
We got to the 100 likes.
We get 15 minutes. Yeah, but I called 250. I called 250 to get there to play it again. What's it at? I'm sure 263. Look. Fine. All right. Yes.
I love Jesse. He's always having fun.
Yes,
Jesse was picked fourth. Yeah, we didn't think he'd be there at the time. Now we've watched him play, we know he'll be just fine. Jesse's got himself some skills, should be on McDavid's line. And Akins would have loved his eyes, and McClellan loves that body, you just know it. And now he's holding both his arms way, way up high. No doubt about it, that was Jesse's goal. Nobody but Jesse's goal. Let's start planning a parade. The Oilers finally decided to make some change. You know I feel so dirty when he starts playing cute. We complain about the Hall trade, but the point is probably moot. And Akins would have loved his eyes.
Yes, you do.
And McClellan loves that body, you just know it. And now he's holding both his arms way, way up high. No doubt about it, that was Jesse's goal. Nobody but Jesse's goal. How did he learn to finish like that? That's Jesse's goal.
Oh, that was a good one, Saturday. I wasn't even thinking. You were more on this train than me today, which I really
well,
like.
Just with everything happening. And again, we don't have a Lakers song yet, but if we did, you would have played it today following the double overtime win last night.
Well, I mean,
the Bucks,
what
the Bucks of all people.
I mean, Austin Reeves, triple-double last night, logo 3 to keep it close late. Absolutely incredible.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Yeah, exactly.
All right, let's get to your text of the day today. Rick, can you bring up the text from the burglarer?
Yes.
I think we have to go with that one. Like, come on. This is great.
And that's a teeth being factored into two straight texts.
He won the one yesterday.
Yes.
And this one's
one,
this
one
is
moment,
good.
Please. Oh, here it is.
I found it. Oh, I found it. I'm good. Yeah. Burglarer. Wheels running into Dusty and Lieutenant Eric after cleaning his glasses for the first time ever.
Who the hell are you all of a sudden?
We see a thief at all of our events. He's always got his glasses. They're filthy. He cleans them off, rolled up.
Just,
who the hell are you all of a sudden?
Everything's a shock and a surprise.
All right, burglar, congratulations, buddy. Gift certificate to A&W. Two Mama Burgers right now for $9.99. It's been a fun day here today inside the Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen Studios. Pick up a flounder for lunch today. You're going to love it. Flounder sandwich. I like the black and chicken sandwich. Never disappoints. I might actually get a black and chicken sandwich today. We'll see.
And get the flounder, too.
A flounder.
Half, keep the other half in your fridge or freezer.
I should take flounders home for the family. Big fish family.
Fish, they like the fish, hey?
They love the fish.
Oh, man.
They'd probably...
be a hero for your household
today.
They'd
probably like that one.
You slumsy poop!
I mixed that in on the Foley Harvey song. You clumsy poop.
Those drops were good.
Hey, Wednesdays is going to be classic, I think, moving forward. I like that. What are you watching tonight, buddy?
What are you watching tonight? Well, as you've been kind of previewing all day, light night in the NHL, pair of games to which I'm sure you and Huss will get at. Just in depth.
Luckily, today for us, we have Houston open, which doesn't have a great field either.
But
we got some more MLB futures coming your way in the
big night
shop.
In the NBA.
And then, yay, Gary Bettman, awesome. Two games.
Yeah, Bolts and Bruins from Tampa, Sabres and Sens from Buffalo. But again, dream of Thursday night. A lot of good matchups there. I guess tonight watching, I mean, and there's not even the grapefruit and cactus leagues. You got that one day before opening season, so you're just kind of standing around like Travolta in the room, you know, looking and pointing. And not much. I don't know. Maybe it's one of those days where you dust off a movie or a show you've been watching or something like that, right? Like, this is kind of like the dog days of summer where you get on a season or a series.
I'm doing an NFL break tonight.
Okay. There we go. Crack packs. Yeah, getting the crack pack.
Might have to hop in the old Pit Stop Pals with Gager tonight, too.
Why not? Well, again, dressed. No show Friday. Tomorrow will be our last of the week.
Beer of the week. Hot takes.
Crack pack.
Blue Jays jacket for opening day. That's great. By the way, speaking of the Blue Jays, but Tina from our contact over at A&W, by the way, she says that was awesome.
Well, if we get...
So that's good.
Good.
That's
mission good. Accomplished.
But also passing this along, every Blue Jays win, projected to win around 86 to 90, every Blue Jays win scores you a free A&W offer only on the app. How about this? So when the Jays win, you get a free A&W offer on the app. So download the A&W app, and when the Jays win, there will be a free A&W offer that pops up.
And playoffs or no playoffs, you're getting in on the deal there. They're going to win games.
How did I not know about this before? Tina, you should have told me about a month ago. This is great. But opening day tomorrow, download the A&W app. When the Jays win, you get a little offer from A&W, which is a great idea too. All right, the Hangout's going to be a good one today. Tommy Gazzola, Matthew Iwanek, Dave Jameson. Tommy, did you hear the A&W song? We killed it. We killed it. Practice pays off. Yeah, I mean.
Thank you, Tom.
Thanks, Tom. That was amazing. You're a talented man. Thanks, Tom. You dishing on handshakes today? This is great.
Trev, too. He's on the shaker.
Trev, he was on the shaker. He was great.
Cold. Stone cold.
All right. Hangout's coming up. Next chance to qualify for the EST Flyway to Vegas with Fly YEG on the Hangout today. Dahmer, J-Mo, Tommy, Iwanek. Chance to qualify. What more could you possibly want? For YouTube, Trev, Lieutenant Eric, I am Dustin Nielsen. Thank you very much for checking out the show today. Subscribe to the channel. We'll be back tomorrow. Take it easy.